Well, yeah, closer to you.
I, hello? So,
I don't cover your damn face, dude. You're good there. Don't read
it. Sugly, anyways.
Don't pick it up there.
Check. Check.
All right, so we got Herman, Nick, man. What's up,
man? Good to see you.
Good to see you, man.
You know, you doing good? Good to see you doing good.
Yeah, I'm doing great, man. We're doing good. How you guys doing down there?
Good, good. We just had a solid sparring session today and, you know.
Fucked some people up like always.
Got lumped up a little bit today, but, you know, that's how it should be, you know.
It happens.
I always say if you're not getting your ass kicked where you are, you should go somewhere else.
Absolutely.
That's how it should be, you know.
Yeah. You got that old school mentality that
yeah.
you gotta murk each other.
Yeah, you gotta go hard. Yeah, you gotta go hard. Otherwise, what's the point?
Well, my philosophy is not get hurt in
the yeah. yeah.
But true. I'm just a boxer. You yeah. know what I mean? I guess in MMA, everything fucking hurts.
Yeah.
Kicks hurt even to defend, I guess. Like
yeah.
So I'm not fucking with getting kicked or choked the fuck out.
Yeah.
That just seems like...
It's a whole other game, though.
You got to put yourself in that situation, because when I did jiu-jitsu with you, the breathing was so different than fucking boxing.
Yeah.
Like, so different. Like, it was just so more demanding. Mm. That fucking gi was hella hot.
Vice versa with boxing, you know? Like, boxing's like, fuck, that shit's hard, you know what I mean? Like, for me, it's really hard, you know? Because you got... Two tools.
Yeah, it's all about the movement too, you know.
Yeah.
Well, we've been watching some of your videos, man. You get some hair movement on there. You're doing combinations and shit.
Nick's
been working on his head movement.
Yeah, I tried to get hit by Herman all the fucking time, so I'm like, I gotta move out of the way.
I saw you doing fucking upper cross upper and
yeah,
shit. Like, dude.
Combos,
yeah.
combos.
I'm not just like walking
yeah,
forward.
No,
punch.
I was watching that shit. I was like, damn, look at
evolving. Evolving, always getting better.
Yeah, man. You gotta be that way in this sport, right? Like,
that's
yeah.
it. That's like the Conor McGregor Mayweather fight. You know what's gonna happen? You know what I mean? Like, in my opinion, like, I think Mayweather is just going in for a good payday because he ain't gonna win that fight. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think a lot of people that think that Conor's just gonna get smoked are stupid. He's big as fuck and he can
yeah.
take punches. Like,
yeah.
The only thing is, like you were saying, is the movement.
It's the
shit,
movement
though, you know,
and
the style's different.
Yeah, I was, are they agreeing to just the boxing or
just boxing?
Yeah. yeah.
Floyd ain't gonna go to MMA.
Yeah.
Floyd's not doing that. It's just in boxing, timing's different. Even if you are a good striker in MMA,
yeah.
if you don't have boxing timing and movement and distance, it becomes a whole different thing. Because remember, Conor has to also keep in mind kicks.
Yeah.
So his distance, his in and outs are a little different.
His range is way different.
Than just a boxing range. We could actually shell up and still be in range to hit you.
Yeah.
And
he's
hit,
always
Conor.
Trying to keep,
yeah.
If you see his posture, he's always trying to keep
distance.
You at the very end of his punch.
Yeah.
He has a nasty left hand. He could take shots. I don't know where people are getting that Floyd's going to knock out a 170-pound fucker. Like, he...
Yeah.
And if he makes weight 145, though, that's, like, crazy. You know?
He's going to
yeah.
drain himself.
I think he can do it every
but he
day.
Gets,
yeah.
he gets 2 pounds extra because in
yeah.
boxing is 147.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So it's 147. And then if they can agree in the catch weight, because Floyd has fought at 154.
Oh, has he?
Yeah, he's fought multiple. He fought Canelo at 54.
Yeah,
he fought Cotto at 54.
Because I don't think Conor can
So if they do 150.
Yeah, like,
that's why he gave the belt
you know?
Up.
Yeah,
know?
He's like, yeah, he's like,
yeah. yeah, so if he does 152, the higher they go in weight, I think the more dangerous Conor is going to be.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
For
like,
me, I think he should just have more respect for the craft. You
yeah.
know? It's just like Michael Jordan. You know what I'm saying? Like, to Tiger Woods, hey, man, I'll fucking beat your ass in golf.
Yeah.
You know, like, hey, man, like, you're an athlete. That's like yeah. me. I'm an athlete. But it's two different worlds.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah, you work hard. You train hard. We train hard here, too. You know, put the
yeah.
time in. But at the end of the day, like, you're a perfectionist at your craft. MMA. I'm a perfectionist at my craft.
Absolutely.
Boxing. Don't come and tell me you're going to demolish me in my craft.
Yeah. Exactly.
Because,
like,
I mean, Floyd has no chance.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Floyd has no chance in MMA. He
yeah.
gets fucking murked.
Yeah.
Murked.
But
quick.
He knows that, and he's smart, and he's not
smarter.
Portraying the fight that way. The fight's coming to him.
Yeah, exactly.
Terms.
He's making, yeah.
So you're stepping into his world,
yeah.
his territory, and his craft. And it's like, hey, if you're so good at boxing, why did you do MMA? Why
yeah.
did you go to boxing in the beginning?
Yeah.
You know, like, you want to go right to the top.
Do you feel like Conor's hurting the sport or helping it?
For MMA?
For MMA.
I think he's helping it, man, because he spoke up and he's getting his worth, you know?
Yeah.
Finally.
Them paydays,
you
right?
You don't give a fuck about
yeah.
what the other fighter, I mean, what the organization's going to say, because he goes in and he brings it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Are
yeah.
the pays from MMA and boxing that much different?
The pay?
Yeah.
Oh, tremendous.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Dude, the guys on the undercard or the main card make what the guys in the main event fight make.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
The thing is,
$250,000
only like, televised boxing gets paid good.
I was gonna say, yeah.
We talked about last time. Televised boxing gets paid good, but like any other motherfucker that's not on TV isn't good. But that's what they're saying. These motherfuckers are on TV.
Yeah.
And it's a pay per view. This should get paid a lot more.
Like, there's Pacquiao and Mayweather, you know, like imagine the fighters on the undercard of that card. They're making at least 100 G's.
Yeah.
Minimum. The lowest is probably 50. Yeah. But still, how many, I mean, main card fighters at the UFC are even making that?
Amanda Nunes makes more than any female boxer.
Yeah, what's the payout on that one?
She got 200K.
Plus her bonus. Yeah. She's the defending champ.
Yeah. That's nothing. Ronda got
$3 million.
She's the challenger. She got $3 million. That's ridiculous.
That's fucked up. Yeah.
Did Amanda get that bonus?
And they promoted
the shit so much. That's what pissed me. That's what I was like.
And they didn't give the champion the respect she deserved.
Yeah. I wasn't trying to hate on Ronda, but I'm like, it's her fans are making me hate her because it's like, fuck you guys. Like,
I mean, let's be realistic. Who really thought she was going to come and wreck?
I didn't think she was going to come. I thought it was fucked up for the promotion and for Evan backing her, who even let her do that.
That was
like,
a
off for a whole year, and then your first fight back somebody gets a champ.
It's a
like,
monster, dude.
You gotta get that.
I think she's really that good.
Yeah.
The problem is, I think she stopped believing in herself that way.
Yeah.
But her boxing's always been terrible. Like, when I see her hit pads, it's a fucking joke. Like,
yeah.
What the fuck are you talking about? Like, it's just, there is the guy just standing there and she's just really fast, little pity pad. That shit don't work. Amanda Nunes let her know. When you're a real striker, you're fucking launching shit. You're turning like Anderson, like Connor, they turn their fucking punch.
Yeah.
It's not like a ta 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 to land a kick.
It's not tapping.
It wasn't like a setup. Like Amanda was throwing real fucking shots.
Yeah.
Like, she was throwing. I watched that bitch. It was 48 seconds. Fuck, yo.
She was throwing.
Well, I posted Real Boxing Beats Bullshit Boxing. For the Dominic fight.
Yeah.
Because Dominic acts like he has this crazy, and his boxing's terrible.
Uh-huh.
And Cody's is not. Cody had a background in real amateur boxing.
Yeah.
You could see how he standing, how he countered. The whole flinging of the arms, like, that shit was sloppy to me. Like, I never saw, like, for them to say he had some of the best box, because that's not real boxing.
He had good movement. Like, Cody, he was really good at movement.
Yeah, his dynamic style.
But those angles?
Unorthodox, and it was hard for
people out for a while.
It wasn't the traditional, you know, kickboxing with wrestling style MMA. He really is good at mixing it up.
Cody was able to time him because he has real boxing. And in real boxing, if you have a sloppy, swinging kind of cat, you just kind of wait and make him come to you because he's going to overextend.
Too much time thrown.
See, everybody was coming and Dominic was able to turn him and spin him.
And
Cody kind of waited and made him overreach.
Well, when I was watching, I didn't see the whole fight. I just saw the highlights. But when I was watching it, it seemed like Cody was just out-Dominicking Dominic. You know, like, I feel like Cody
did a lot of the head shit, doing
the same thing that Dominic was doing. In my opinion, they're doing the same thing.
But watch the head movement of Cody's was here, 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 and turning and doing proper shit.
Uh-huh.
Dominic would end up hands down, turn, and then pop.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Jamey just came in.
What you got over there? I was like, what do you mean?
You can. Hands like these, you can show whatever.
So just the movement, to me, like, seeing it as a boxing coach, I was just seeing the proper slips and rolls and turns he was doing.
Yeah.
And how he was walking Dominic. He was making Dominic walk a certain way with his angle.
Yeah.
The way he was controlling the ring, it was like, or the octagon, he was like controlling it pretty good. And that's what I saw was the kind of difference where, like, Dominic must have not thought he could do that shit because the other fucker was always coming forward.
Yeah.
And he fucked with him. And
I felt like a lot of it was lead up to the fight too. They're both getting each other's heads a lot. Yeah. You know, they're both fucking each other.
Yeah.
I mean, I like the fight. I just thought Cody's boxing was more proper than Dominic's. In my view, the properness.
Yeah.
Where he showed a bit more proper stuff to me. It was just like, oh shit. That's why I was like, proper boxing, let's do bullshit boxing. But that's just boxing. Like, I don't know about kicks. I'm not gonna sit there
and
give my opinion on some fucking kicks or on some fucking chokes or I'm not gonna give all that. But when I watch MMA, I just kinda focus on the stand up. Connor was just pulling shit. But you can pull that distance that he pulls is fucking incredible. Yeah. Like,
just well, he Mayweathered like, everybody, boom, you know?
Bam.
Yeah. You know, the
boom, and just pulled him. Yeah.
And that's why I think that Mayweather will have the edge on him in the boxing ring because that's his forte. He's been doing it for a long time. He knows how to control the distance in that part.
And
it'll make him overextend because even though he's longer, he's not going to play the distance game with him, he's gonna make him overextend and make him.
Yeah, yeah, he's gonna make him fall.
You know what I mean? I mean, the guy's the best.
Floyd's not gonna.
You know, you don't get that. You don't get that way. Just fucking. You know,
hang on him and say this and that, but you know, until you can beat him, you know, then.
And this motherfucker's been doing it for 20 years, man. Like you said, when I started, that motherfucker was a little boy.
Yeah.
And that's true. Experience is a motherfucker. Like, if you're going to go in there thinking just because you're strong and young, experience plays a huge fucking part.
Yeah.
On shit like that.
And a lot of it, too, I find with, like, MMA is, like, I mean, for any sport, really. It's, like, your fans will start hyping you up to the point where you think
you're a little higher than
you
are.
Yeah, you know? Like, I'm not saying, like, Conor's obviously a fucking badass, and he backs up, like, all that shit that he's saying. But at the same time, it's like, you know, that's how you get carried away, you know? You're like, oh, you'll fuck Lloyd up. You're like, yeah, well, you know, then you fire up, you're like, shit.
That's the mental aspect that you got to separate and know, like, people don't see the hard work he puts in the back scenes.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Like, don't forget, like, he's talking like that because probably, you know, he's seen the difference himself. He's seen himself evolve. He's feeling himself evolve his training, but he's doing the work. Yeah. You know what I mean? So he's feeling that confidence and talking it. Like, if you're sitting around and just talking is one thing, but if you're doing the work and you're working your ass off and you're sparring high-level guys that are high-level too, and you're pulling the shit off that you couldn't do before, that's when the confidence comes in. You know what I mean? Because you're putting in the time and the work and it's showing. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Versus just like saying it like, oh, I think I can do this.
Yeah.
Like,
or you fire yourself up one day, you know.
Right. You're actually seeing it in the gym. But of course, in the gym and in the big shows, it's two different places, you know? Like, when the lights are all on you, the pressure's on, you know, you're representing your school, your family, your friends, whatever. You know what I mean? Like, then things change. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that's when you're going to see recording? Like, how talented you really are. You know, can you do it then?
A lot of static.
You
know?
It's a lot of static.
Hold on. Cables.
Hold on.
That's probably this one right here.
Technical difficulties.
I knew it was that one. I'm going to save some high problems. You go ahead, Herman. You can still talk.
Got to carry the team, Herman.
Check one, check one. Is it still static when you talk?
No. We're good. It's yours.
Is it still?
No, it's better. The whole time has been
real
staticky, man.
All right, that's nice. Hey, check if that shit's recording the main program.
Yeah, stop streaming, start recording. Yeah, it's good.
All right, so we're good.
I'm on the main program.
All right, so yeah, so we had some difficulties. We had to adjust. It's all Jamie's fault.
Yeah, yeah, fucking everything's going good till you walked in and the lasagna.
Like, so any of you guys got fights coming up or?
Me, nothing right now, but I'm hoping this is going to be a good year for me. You know, I'm just getting back into serious training, you know, 3-4 days, getting back on the diet and stuff like that and trying to get my mind right and see what happens this year.
Was it just the business side of it that kind of like made you fall back, or was it just missed opportunities, or what was it that got you from being like on Bellator and being that at, because you reached one of the highest levels, obviously, in MMA, going into Bellator.
Yeah, that and like there was a little bit of change in the organization and stuff like that. So obviously, you know, it's like you have leeway with the people that were there before, and then the everything changes and they're like, they don't know who you are, you know? So they're going to favor their people. You know, nevertheless, if you're a talented fighter, obviously you're going to get to where you deserve to be.
Yeah.
You know, it's just at that point when you give everything for someone and then they offer you a deal, but it's like, ass backwards from what you had, you know, and it's like, hey man, like, I'm moving up, I'm not going backwards, I'm not gonna take fights for 10 times tougher guys for a quarter of the money I was getting before for okay, decent guys, you know, or whatever, you know, tough guys, whatever, you know, not to take away from the guys I fought before, but you want to move forward, you know what I mean? So it's like, if you're making, you know, 6-6 to fight, and before you got a little bit more, like 12-12 or 15-15, whatever, you know, it's like, hey man, like, You're already breaking your money apart before you get it. You know what I mean? Like, if I don't win, 7,000 of it's going to my camp.
Yeah.
If that's gone, then I got taxes, you know, and then what am I left with? Now, if I win, there's some chance, you know what I mean? Like, so of course you want to win, you know, you're going to put everything you got.
And that's the thing about people don't get, like, the percentages you give coaches, managers.
Oh, yeah, they just see the outcome.
Like, they just see, like, oh, he won 300 million. No, he didn't.
No, the past,
he saw it. Yeah, he saw 300 million for a second.
It came significantly down.
Yeah, everyone's like this, you know?
So so that's why even taking small shows is a risk, because, like, you're making shitty money. Like you said, win or lose still, like, you're making such little money, then it has to trickle down to everybody. Yeah. Thing that was.
And there's always risk of getting injured. You can always get injured. Like, who cares? Like, a big show, little show, doesn't matter. Like,
Camp cost.
Just catch one. Yeah.
Anything can happen. You know?
Then camp's cost. The food. Like, you guys have the luxury to have a good, solid squad. So you guys have good training camp. But when you don't have it, you either have to fly motherfuckers in, or you have to fly there.
Right.
Or, and it costs a lot of money. And if you're not making significant dough, you're hesitant to just take a small fucking fight because you're like, fuck, what if I break my hand?
Yeah.
Where is this taking me? Is this fight going to be seen by who?
Yep.
How are they promoting it?
Exactly.
Like with me, what I do with my shit, that's why I do the podcast. That's why I get people. Like, I have to promote myself as a brand.
Yeah.
Because I'm a small entity. I'm not a ginormous gym. I don't have tons of fucking fighters that I could promote as much.
Yeah, you got your name.
So I have to start branding myself in different ways. How do I promote myself? How am I here? How am I there? Like, you got to be seen.
Yeah.
Or you're not, you know, like you said, you have all the fucking talent in the world. Yeah. No one fucking sees you ever. Where are you going to get to? Like,
that
where
who you know, you know?
Yeah.
You know, some guys get a little bit farther because who they know, you know? It's bullshit. Some of the guys, they don't even deserve to be there, but who they know, you know
who
what I
mean? Got them there, yeah.
And they're there and they play it safe and shit like that, but.
Is it sometimes better just to fucking try to find, because I'm sure a ton of fighters go to the bigger camps.
Yeah.
Like American Top Team or
Jackson Winkle.
They go to these big camps to see eventually the growth.
Yeah.
Like, you'll see all the little guys will go to the Alpha Milk thing because they have that shit. That's their thing.
That makes sense. You want to go to a place where there's really good guys that are consistent, that have the same goals, and they're the same weight class, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But again, like, it's a double-edged sword, you know? Like, do you want to be with the guys that are in that circuit too? No, because then, you know, you're training with them. The next thing you know, you're fighting each other.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
and then, I mean, they could just use you too as a fucking human punching bag and shit. And,
I think there's nothing wrong with, like, I don't mind small camps, you know?
Yeah.
But I think there's a lot of, like, cross-training every once in a while.
Right.
Just to test yourself. Like, I'll go up to Vegas, you know, and train with the shooting tour guys. I love going up there because they're all solid dudes up there.
Yeah.
And it's still cool to just go up there every once in a while and just test myself against them, see if I can hang.
Against the guys in the circuit, you know?
Yeah, you know? You don't have to be with them. You know, I think we have a good thing going, like, our camp.
Yeah.
Undisputed. And, but I still, like, you know, it's still cool to go out and test yourself against other camps. And, you know,
That's what I was going to come to. Like, with San Diego, like, is it easy for you guys just to go to other camp, or is this the hate too much?
No. I mean, I'm not like that at all.
Like,
I mean,
where people are like, we don't want to bring
this here. There's some that will do that. Yeah.
Where I'm like, fuck, I'm not even in MMA and I'm hearing shit. I'm like, goddamn, really? What the fuck?
There's some where, like, because everyone wants to know, like, what your agenda is, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, I purely just want to go so I can just test myself and hang out, like, train. But there's others who are like, well, what, like, you're trying to steal our moves, or you're trying to scout, you know?
Undisputed had a way more reputation than the one now, right? The old Undisputed, like, when they first branched off from us, from City.
Yeah.
When I was at City and they first branched off, and then Brandon branched off and went to Alliance. And you started seeing Brandon, Rudy, and all them went to Alliance. You guys all went to North Park started.
Yeah.
And all that. Back then, it seemed like there was more of, like, the competitor, because there was not that many gyms.
Yeah.
And as soon as all these MMA gyms now, everybody's just like, fuck them.
Yeah, and it's
weird. I feel like back then, you guys were progressing faster because you had the work. Like, you guys were the top
three. The camaraderie was there too, though, you know?
Yeah.
Everyone was helping each other, but The bottom line is, like I always say, like, you don't gotta go here, in my opinion, you don't gotta go there just because, oh, they got so-and-so, this guy's the best.
Yeah,
of course, it's good to train with the best, but at the same time, you're not that person.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
You can't do what that person
can. Like, when you fight someone, like, oh, you got him in the corner. Like,
I'm
not fighting that dude. Yeah.
All I agree is, like, you have your solid core of guys that everyone shows up, and everyone works hard. And that's it. You know, there's nothing different if you look at all the gyms anywhere in the world. You know, the best gyms. Like, oh, what are those guys doing? What's their
nothing special.
What's their system? I've been there to those gyms, you know. And, like, everyone, the only thing that's different that makes other gyms more successful than others is that everyone shows up and works hard.
It's about consistency.
No matter what, because everyone has the same goal.
Yeah.
It's when, you know, people don't show up and it's like, fuck, you got to hustle training partners and shit. It's like, well, then you're hurting too. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, everyone gets better, you know what I mean, when everyone's there together.
And I feel some of these gyms aren't necessarily better, they just have better promotion.
Yeah, yeah.
They're not necessarily
sure.
better fighters. They just have better marketing and promotion, right, right. and they have the money to put it out there. Because I don't necessarily feel other gyms are necessarily better or any shit like that because they just have better they have more money.
Their names are on more people's mouths.
And they could put it and expand more and put more shit like that, you know? And so, like you brought a bunch of, like, you know, Jamey over here, Nick, and a lot of guys that came under you, you know what I'm saying? And you're still fairly young.
Yeah.
So that's fucking crazy, you know what I'm saying? To have some of these guys still come up under you. Like, did you feel that way? Like, when you were coming up in Guam, like, you had young, hungry dudes that were fucking stomping you out, and you were just like, I'm gonna get there, motherfucker.
Yeah, I was the young dude. I was the one showing up to the gym every day, getting my fucking head kicked in, you know what I mean? Like, and come back, and I'm like, oh, you're back again? Like, oh, guess what? Today's gonna be the same, motherfucker.
It's gonna be harder.
Like, shit, man. Like, what the fuck, you know? Like, but that's that thing of testing the heart, you know? But I think MMA has changed a little bit, you know?
Yeah.
From back then, because I, like, got the tail end of the old school era, you know? Like, back then, it was more about being tough than skillful, you know?
Like,
you better be tough. Like, you better not fucking quit, you know? But I believe that 100%, because if you don't have that, then you're a waste of fucking time.
And that's just, you can't teach it, right?
Yeah, exactly. That's something that you can't teach. You can always teach someone how to jab, throw punches, you know, do jiu-jitsu, whatever, you know what I mean? That can be taught. Obviously, it's proven, you know? But when it comes down to it, when that shit's not working for you, and you're fucking super tired, and you're fucking getting your head pounded, you know, what's going to push you through? Your heart, you know?
Like, you know, like, shout out to fucking Ron. He's not here.
I know.
Ron is a motherfucker, dog. Seeing Ron, like, come up, like, from, like, I was only at Undisputed, like, a year and a half. But in that year and a half, seeing the way his body changed, his physique, and how much his technique was improving, and that's just testament of your guys' group.
Yeah.
Because, you know,
it's
saying?
Not only just physique, it's like mentally too, he's more confident.
He was a machine. He was just getting punched. So he had that shit you're saying. Well, he had no fear.
Yeah, he came a long way, but he had a heart. You know
what I mean? He's probably one of those hearts in the team.
Shout out to Ron.
That's why he's called the Roninator.
You know? I like wake up with like a sore back and like, I'm gonna skip practice today. You know, like Ron's coming in like a fucking broken ankle. Yeah, he's like, I'm cool. I'll just punch with this one. You know.
Yeah, I'm good, man. Let's go.
He's like, fuck. Yeah. But I know, like, today, you're like, oh, I think I broke John. Like, today in practice, we're sparring. I look over, and Herman and Ron are stopped. And I was like, what? He's like, I think I broke Ron's jaw. Like, Ron's like looking in the mirror. He's like, you know? So I'm like, oh, fuck. It's like, keep sparring. I look back. He comes back and starts sparring again.
Yeah.
It's like, what the fuck? That's a savage, though. Yeah. But that's testament of, like, your old school background on how to teach motherfuckers and putting that mindset on some people, because some people might have the skill but might not have the heart. When shit gets harder than you expect, like in one of my fights, I'm so used to being like flashy and slick, and then I got a fucking 6'6" just country fed white boy that was just doing this shit, you know what I mean?
Taking the heat.
Anything I hit him with, nothing happened.
Blast as hard as you can, it's still popping for you.
But then psychologically, that fucked with me. And I lost that fight.
Yeah.
How does that fuck you up when you hit him with your
bitch shit?
Tell him when you kicked the homeboy.
Oh, when I fought in Oklahoma, you know, like, the guy missed weight. This big ass Brazilian guy, you know, missed weight. Marcio Navarro, you know, like, he missed weight by like fucking 13 pounds.
God damn.
Oh, shit. He didn't even try to make it.
His buddy's like, fuck this weight.
You know, he's a hometown guy, whatever, you know? So it's like, hey, man, we're fucking here already, whatever. We're going to fucking do the fight, you know? Like, let's fucking go, you know? I'm here to fight. And we go in there, you know? And like, oh, don't worry, you know, he's only got 3 MMA fights, you know, but he's a fucking black belt in jiu-jitsu, and he's got fucking like 60 Muay Thai fights, you know what I mean, in Brazil, and it's like the crazy ones, you know, like fucking no glove shit, you know what I mean,
like kick him on the ground,
with the glasses, he's roping shit,
so like, I go in there, I fucking kick him in the leg as hard as I can, like, nice one, you know, he like, shakes it off, I'm like, fucking, whash! Oh, he smashed, break his nose, and he's like, he's coming forward. I was like, fuck! Oh, shit, you know? Like, what the fuck, you know what I mean?
That shit is a scary feeling. I'm like,
It sucks.
It's like, hey, you know, it's like, fuck, well, either I'm gonna keep going or I'm gonna get fucking crushed, but who cares, you know? Like, I'm in here ready to fucking do this.
Because
you know?
At my point in my fight, like, my technique had nothing to do with it no more. He did not care how slick I was, he was just walking forward. I could hit him, pop, nothing.
Yeah.
And then I dropped him, but he just got up like the Undertaker. Yeah. Like, you know, like that quick, like, just get him?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, fuck. God, that psychologically drains you. You start, like, hyperventilating a little more. Like, your training, it starts where, like, that shit you have kicks in.
Yeah.
That's why I feel like cultures that come from that background
are successful.
Because that's when that fucking, that last thing you have is that fight or flight. And, and cultures that either beat it into you or breed it into you. Yeah. But
and that's the thing I think that's dying out, my personal opinion, in MMA today. You know, I think it's going soft, you know. Some people might say whatever, you know. Like, some people might say my mentality is dumb and it's stupid. It's brute, not smart. Like, you're not going to have longevity in the sport. But, again, to me, it's not a sport. Yeah. I'm not a sportsman. I'm it's not in there to be
an athlete. That's what we were talking about last time. Like,
I'm not a sport. Simple, man. Like, you score points and the guy who scores, the team, whatever, scores more points wins, right? I'm not in there to score a point. I'm in there to fucking smash your face.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or I'm going to get my face smashed trying to do it. Right? Yeah. There's two ways, you know? That's the way I fight. You know what I mean?
But that's combat. Like, you're in combat.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We're in the quote-unquote sport where that other person knowingly and is acknowledging to hurt you. Like,
for sure.
My goal is to fuck you up.
Yeah, and he's thinking the same thing.
In the same thing, yeah.
No matter what anyone says, you know?
So there's no longer like that.
Oh, there's a mutual respect. Yeah, man.
After.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Yeah. After, of course. I'll shake your hand, you know, because I'm going to give you everything I got. And you're going to give me everything you got. And then the respect level is totally different.
Yeah, exactly.
You never look at the person the same.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's like, in the time being, it's like, hey, motherfucker, it's me or you. And guess what? I'm going to make sure I'm going to do everything I fucking can to make sure it's not me. You know what I mean?
Well, when I went to jiu-jitsu with you, I fucking stayed up like 3 nights researching like a motherfucker.
Because
I was like, these fuckers are going to be like, let's get the boxing coach and fuck them up.
Yeah.
So like, I thought Herman was going to old school me. Like, fuck it, just get in there.
Yeah.
You know, like, not teach me like he was teaching you. I thought he was just going to be, and I was prepared for that. I was like, cool, Herman's gonna bring that old school shit. Fuck it, I'm a fighter. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
I'll do it. But then when I started going in there, their overconfidence slipped up that I could learn shit quick. I knew some shit, I've done it before. So I was on bar, motherfuckers, but because of their overconfidence. When you were telling them, hey, it's his first fucking day, motherfucker. Like,
they lay back, nonchalant. Like, oh,
you try to grab onto stuff, like, oh, I let him, and then you're like, oh, fuck, wait a minute.
I was thinking it like how you grew up as a, like, in my culture, fighting is fucking king. It's up there with soccer. It's the top two sports, whether it's boxing, but it's fighting. So you learn to fight. You have to have that fighter mentality. So when I went in there, I didn't go in there like, well, fuck no. I was like, I'm not getting choked up by nobody. I'm not getting choked up by nobody. Like, I took it serious.
No one wants to try something and suck at it.
I don't want to disrespect the coach. Like, if I'm going in to take your sport and you're allowing me to come in and shit, I'm not going to disrespect it.
Yeah.
Vice versa. That's something, you know.
Like, I'm going to go try my hardest.
That's Connecticut, you know?
Yeah.
If you don't know about it, you'll learn about that.
Like, yeah.
I'm going to go in there and try my hardest because I don't know what to expect.
Yeah.
I don't know if everybody wants to choke me out because I'm the boxing. Because you'll see gyms like that. Like, oh, the boxing guy, let's fuck him up.
Yeah.
So, you know, it goes both ways. Because even we boxers, when we get a fucking guy that's just ground and comes into the ring, we start pegging them and touching it, you know.
It's also how you act too, though. You know, some people will step into a gym.
Yeah.
And like, things are going to run shit.
Everyone's like, oh, you're fucking creepy.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Like, you get like shit talkers.
You ain't walking out here.
Yeah.
This fucking doors, we're not being like, oh yeah, those guys are tough, man. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
like,
if you're leaving the gym.
That's Herman's philosophy, man.
Yeah.
Herman's philosophy.
It's gotta be, you know, that's how you get
that.
You
come to my gym, you're gonna leave knowing what's up. Like,
yeah.
You'd be like, either, you know, those guys are legit, or, you know what I mean? Like, fuck, those guys.
Because if you're going out, anyone will leave the gym and be like, nah, fucking smash all those guys.
Yeah,
suck.
So just know that if you go down the speed to do MMA, you're going to get smashed.
Yeah, I mean, like,
or you're going to have a good sparring session.
Just know that if you come, you come with your A game, you know. Don't come in there thinking, you know, anything.
I go to other gyms thinking that, too. You know?
Exactly.
Like, I already know, like, hey, man, the target's on my back.
Yeah.
Like, you're not on the team, motherfucker.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, Julio got an experience like that going up north to box.
Yeah.
And he went in there all friendly, and they lumped him up. And I was like, yeah, go in there. Yeah,
it's all about, come in respectful.
It'll only be like that first time. And if you come back again, then it's different. Because, you know, like
we know your head's at.
Yeah.
Well, the mutual respect is there, you know. It's different, like, knowing someone and shaking hand. But when you punch each other in the fucking face and try to choke each other, you know what I mean? After, it's like, hey, man, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I gotta shake your hand, you know what I mean?
Yeah. We're like
close friends. Yeah. Every time we spar, we're trying to fuck each other out. Like, he's trying to knock me out, I'm trying to knock him out.
You always find that teammate. Like, now it's me and Julio. Back in city, I had James, James Thomas. So back in the day, you find that guy that could push you.
Yeah, and that's why you do that hard practice the first time, because this is serious for us, you know. Yeah, like, we're going in there, it's fucking our lifestyle. Yeah. I don't want you come in there and fucking waste my time. Like,
do you think it's disrespectful? Time. Like, if he came in like that, came in like 100%.
Yeah, you know, it just sucks because I don't want to go in there and you're just like that much better than
you. Like, I can take a light on you. Like, bitch, you better come with it. Like,
exactly.
Yeah.
Which sucks because you're not, you know, like, you know, you got it. Like, I'm not saying try to knock each other's
heads off. My rule is this: speak first, talk. Yeah. We're going hard. Established.
Yeah.
Don't say, hey, we're going light, and I start light, and then you fucking peg me.
Yeah. Because that's when you really.
That's like chicken bullshit.
That's bullshit. Yeah. Like, come on.
So that's what I'm saying. Like, there's a difference, you know. Like,
you'll see, like, gym bullies.
It all depends, like, how they're, what they're coming for. You know, like, I'm coming to get some cross training in. You know, I'm getting ready for a fight, boom, boom. You know, they'll kind of lay it out. But if they're like, hey, I'm a fucking fighter, what's up? I'm coming in shape. Hey, motherfucker, well, we're
going to
test that.
Yeah, like, you're okay.
We want to know if you're legit, you know?
Typical 100.
But if you're like, hey, man, I got a fight coming up. I'm fighting in this blah, blah, blah. I'm fighting so-and-so.
I'm just trying to get some work
in. Yeah, man, that's cool. You know, we're going to work, you know? But if you're like, yeah, man, like, what are you guys about? You know, like, I've had 50 street fights or like 60 MMA fights. Oh yeah, what's your record on Sure Dog? What the fuck, Sure Dog? Oh yeah, you know, we already know you're
Cool, man. Yeah.
You're already fucked up.
Hey, you know? Gloves over there. Come on in. Yeah.
Jose turned some guy away because of that. He came in. He was like, oh, I don't need to defend myself because I had 80 million street fights.
I was trying to explain to him, like, well, people come to my gym for personals or just cardio if you want to learn to defend yourself. He's like, I don't need to learn to defend myself. I was like, thank you, and I just walked in.
I'm not gonna sit out here.
I don't need to hear this shit. I don't have any street fights you have. Like, you know, we all have street fights. And if you found one of us in the fucking street, you fucked up.
Yeah.
People need to understand that you can't be that confident in the street, motherfuckers.
We're just talking about the car.
Like,
The situations, you know, like even me, you know, like if some asshole cuts me off or whatever, you know, like
I have road rage too.
You see the road the road rage people, like there some guys, you know, they're like, hey, motherfucker, they're like, dude, pull over, and it's like, man, you don't even know who the fuck you're talking to.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that's what I'm thinking, you know? Like,
well, me and you talked about that, remember?
Yeah, like, it's like fighting, you know, I know how to fight. I know how to defend myself intelligently. That's why I don't say fight. Like, I say, like, I know intelligently how to defend myself.
Yeah.
And if you look at the average 1 out of 10 males out there do. You know what I mean? It's 1 out of 10. I'm not saying you took fucking 3 months Muay Thai classes and you don't know anything yet. You know, like, intelligently, you get into a real scrap where the guy's gonna fucking bring everything. What are you gonna do?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're gonna check his kick and then counter? No, you're not. That shit goes out the window.
Yeah. You're
gonna fucking react off of instinct. And if you don't have that fucking instinct, you're gonna get fucking creamed, you know?
Yeah.
But the idea is like, hey, man, why the fuck why are you acting like that? You don't even know who you're honking at. You have no idea who's inside this car. And if I did not really did fight with you, you know what I mean? You don't understand that I'll change your life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, straight up. You know what I mean? Like, you will never be the same person. Like, don't push me. And I carry that the same way. Because you never know who the fuck's behind the car.
Yeah.
And you don't know what they're capable of. They could be some regular guy who fucking pulls a gun and shoots you in the fucking face. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, and then, that's a big motherfucker. Fuck that. Bah!
Yeah, you know? Yeah.
Take every scenario as fight. So we get in real fight mode. We're not taking it lightly. We're not like, oh, this is...
Exactly.
This motherfucker doesn't know. So I'm just assuming you know some shit, so I'm fucking you up. Like,
yeah.
But to these, society is so different. You know, like... You never see that shit before because everyone, you do something, there's like 10 people that are like this, you know, like with their phones. And everyone's all like, so like, oh, this motherfucker's not gonna do anything because he's gonna go to jail. Yeah. Fuck, bro, remember 2003, 1999? Like,
There's no evidence.
No one saw shit. You get your face smashed. And it's it, you know? Like, you talk about it a little circle and then it's done, you know?
Yeah.
But people act right, you know? They don't act up. They don't walk around with their chest puffed.
Robert, everyone's so sheltered
ain't
these
nobody
days.
Scared of no fucking prison yeah. cholos yeah. you got over there, motherfucker. Yeah. Fight, don't fight. Don't give no fuck about that.
But I saw Ted. Yeah, Ted's
yeah,
talking
Ted,
shit too.
Ted
yeah.
said he's gonna fuck you two up. You didn't say me. Yeah, cool. Thanks, Ted. By the way, there's a little white boy in the back, Jamey. Yeah. He's still there. You can see. Yeah. We can see you in the corner, Jamey. So when did it like you understood that it was real when you first started? Like, cause you used to when I was there, used to feel like they were bullying you.
I understand.
I understand.
Last Monday,
he's still was, doing that shit.
I'm doing most of them, but like, yeah.
He's a lot better. He's a lot better at it.
Yeah. Like, on last Monday, me and Nick were sparring, and like, I hit my head. Nick hit me good, and I hit my head, and I was just walking down, like, I'm gonna beat your ass, motherfucker. Crazy enough,
like, he takes it out on random yeah, yeah, yeah. kids and shit.
Like, I was just, and I started like, hitting him, and I started laughing, like, what the fuck am I talking?
Yeah, yeah. I was like, you're talking shit, like, bro, like, I can't wait to fuck you up. I was like, God,
it's like that's what I was thinking. I was just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we've all told
that's
you.
That's why
like,
it's because fighting too. Like a lot of people don't understand. Like fighting's like it's a very big mental aspect of it too,
yeah,
where you just gotta, you know, it's one thing to be able to beat someone's ass. It's another thing to be able to control yourself, you know,
yeah.
and think, you know, still have your mind.
The actual
right.
punches and not just fucking swing like a fucking maniac.
Yeah.
But that's what gets me.
Because we all get that way. I'll get that way too. You know, you fucking will get like, especially when it comes
we
to.
We work at the door, so.
Yeah, somebody will fucking crack me a good one. I'm like, oh, that fucking hurt. You know, you're like, what the fucking, yeah.
So you want to get back and beat.
Yeah, exactly.
Sure. Well, that's fighter instinct again,
yeah.
you know?
See,
that's
having
that, you know?
Yeah.
I get, I have
he
like,
has that. I don't think that way. I'm like, when I get hit, I'm like, boom, cool, he hit me. I'm going to analyze it. And then I'm like, okay, I got to fucking. But that's boxing.
Yeah.
Like when I'm boxing, yeah. like I get tagged, like he'll tag me and I'll wait.
You gotta be able to.
And then cool.
Take a
breath.
That's the way you should be.
And
yeah.
then I hit him.
You know, yeah. You
know,
wanna be
like,
that way.
It's simple. You know, it's like when you get punched or kicked, you know, either you cow away from it, you know, you cower away from it, or you're like, fuck you, I wanna punch that person for punching me, you know?
Yeah.
I have that shit. He's trying to check me on that.
Because he does
it's
the,
like,
he
yeah.
does the
you
same
hit me, but
punch.
You know what I'm about? You know what I mean? Like, here it is, you know?
He takes it another level, though. When I hit him
yeah.
with the punch, he wants to hit me with that exact same punch.
Yeah, that,
yeah.
and I'm like, that's a fighter instinct, man. You know?
Yeah.
I'm like,
which is
good.
Like,
you know,
like,
I see
know.
It. Like,
yeah.
I know
but
you're not
knows,
you punch me, but you know I feel this, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like,
I know he's doing it.
It just depends on what yeah. it's like. Me and Nick, like, I like Nick. He's my homie, but like, he's my arch enemy in the gym.
Yeah.
You know, like, since I got to the gym, like, when I'm with, like, we're at training, Nick's at the show, I'm like, and Nick's just fucking sitting there, he's hung over, like, I'm getting
ready. Like, today's the day I'm fucking
like,
him
he's
up.
He's not here, he's losing his race. I'm getting a little closer.
Yeah.
There's always that one up, you know what I mean?
Like, all today.
Yeah, I mean, and he knows that because
that's
good. It is a true.
That's a good thing, you know? Like, there's always that one person or two people that are in there that are like, put it on you, you know what I mean? And they're like,
yeah.
when you get in, you're like, oh, I'm on fire today, motherfucker.
Yeah.
You know what
and
I mean?
You need that. You need that. Because if you're at the top, you're at the top and you're never getting challenged, it's like you're just going to stay at this plateau.
For sure.
You know, like Jamey just said, he's all like, every time I'm not there, he's like, fuck yeah. Like, it's another, like, I'm getting, that's how much better I'm getting that he's getting to me, you know?
Well, that's why I tell you, because like,
you gotta
train it's like the coaching aspect too. Like, you're a coach, but the thing is, like, you know, you see some of these gyms, it's like where the coaches are, like instructors for jiu-jitsu or even coaches for MMA, like they'll always put themselves at the top. And like, that's because like, they think like they're the best or whatever. You can't think like that as a coach, you know, you can't be like, oh, I fucking know everything, da da da. Or your student starts to beat your ass or tag you or catch you, whatever, you know. I look at it as a good thing, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like that means like I'm doing my job as a coach. To instill my student, I'm making him better, and he's gonna be better than me. I always think like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's like raising snakes or fucking pit bulls, you know? Like, sometimes you're gonna get bit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Right? Sometimes you're gonna get bit.
You
I mean,
crazy,
but we're the type of coaches that we used to talk about this. Like, if you're gonna be a fucking coach and talk all this shit, you better get in that fucking ring.
Yeah, that's another thing.
Yeah.
You be able to jump
in
the fire with
that.
The respect level's different.
Yeah, like, you gotta.
Some coaches out there, like, they talk a lot and they don't have enough credentials yet, you know, themselves.
Yeah.
Or they're not willing to jump in the fire with the people, you know what
yeah.
I mean? I jump in the fire with my guys.
Absolutely.
Because I wouldn't teach or preach anything that I wouldn't
do
myself.
Do yourself. Yeah,
you
exactly.
know, and a lot of the things that I teach my guys or instill in them mentally or whatever is things that I've handled, you know, and went through myself through the adversities, and I kind of like tell them like, oh, well, this is what I did that worked for me. Doesn't mean it's gonna work for you, you know, like everyone's different.
Everyone's got their own style.
You know, the way that I look at it is like, as if I look at someone and I see kind of their style and I try to mold them to be good at what they're good at and defend their flaws. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? To better them.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like, oh, you gotta do it like this because this is how I fucking do it. And if you don't do it like this, you're wrong.
Yeah.
You know, that's a wrong way of thinking, you know? Like, you always gotta be open-minded because every day the sport or the style of fighting is evolving. And that's proven today. Yeah. Look at, if you look at the old school style of MMA compared to today, they can't keep up. You know what I mean? Like, you look at GSP, he's like the fucking, you remember X-Men, you know, where like they have the old school Wolverine. It's like one mutant has one power.
Yeah.
And then they fucking develop the super one where he has like everything.
Oh, fuck.
And like
the
Wolverine's like fighting him on that thing. He's like getting his fucking ass kicked. Like, what the fuck? Yeah. That's like the evolved fighter. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, put GSP versus a fucking guy with the one boxing glove.
Like UFC 1. Figuring shit out still, you know?
Right? It's like the hybrid, you know what I mean? Like, it's changed, you know? But the one thing I think should stay in the sport is the purity and the heart and the tenacity of toughness, you know? Like, that they're starting to stray from that. Like, some camps now are be like, oh, you know, like, don't be dumb and don't be a dumb brute. Like, you need to, like, hold him against the cage and get that takedown and get those points.
Playing it safe, like the pace.
Yeah, man, fuck that. You know what I mean? Like, it's a fucking fight. Like, it depends on what you're looking for out of it and what you want to be.
And it's also good to have every style in the gym.
Yeah. Like, well, because where the sport's starting to get to, it's more like you're trying to get fame out of it
For sure.
You're more interested in the press conferences and the fucking everything that comes after the fight. You're not worried about the fight, really.
You gotta enjoy the beauty.
You want to get that win before, you know, like, oh, yeah, I'll just fucking play safe the whole time. Yeah. Oh, I got the belt still, you know, just so you can just go out there and talk about it. Like, fuck that. Like, if you lose, like, I don't, like, we're just, me and Jamie were just talking about it today before we got here. Is all like, I don't give a fuck win or lose. I don't give a fuck if I win or lose. I just want to go out there and, like, fight the best. I want to train as hard as I can and fight the best that I can. Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, you're going to look at yourself in the mirror and be like, oh, fuck, man. Did I really put everything out there?
Yeah.
Did I really challenge myself?
Yeah.
Do you feel that would change once you got to a certain level? Like, because never been to that level.
Yeah.
Do you feel that
you know, say it too.
The influences of people, because it's obviously
people and money.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's easy to say it, but I'm a total, I'm vain as fuck. You know, I like, you know, people talk about me, you know, I'm like, oh yeah, you know. So it's easy to say, like, oh yeah, you know, but I don't care about the fame that comes along with it. You really do.
You want to hold that moral, that upbringing, because like Herman, you know, he's proud of, like, Chamorro and Guam, I'm proud of Mexican. And we have cultures that sometimes we want to bring that fucking thing. And I think once you get Americanized, kind of lose that shit, because there is no background like our background. Like, we're first generation here.
Yeah.
So when we're your first generation,
I was like, look at me, I'm a fucking mutt. Like, I don't have that national, like, pride of, like, oh,
when
I got
you have
this,
the American thing, like,
Americans are national pride.
You want to get the pride. Yeah. I'm saying, what I mean, Americanized is now you're influenced by, like, Floyd's money, Floyd's shit. Like, there's Floyd's not like, yeah, I'm doing this for my country.
Yeah.
Or,
yeah,
you know, like Connor's doing it for Ireland.
Yeah.
That's why he's exploding, because he has a fucking country behind him.
Yeah.
And he's like,
but he's willing to put everything out there for that reason. And that fuels him, you know, because it's in his heart.
Yeah.
In his heart. You know what I mean? Like, you have to.
Connor's from Ireland, stupid. Robert.
Yeah. Floyd Irishman.
You know, but you also get that sense, like, I'm not talking about America's a bad place, because obviously you get the opportunity, like I always say on my podcast, I got the opportunity to open my own shit or have my own stuff and do what I love to do and make money doing it. So I get that opportunity, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's not that, but I'm saying in the sense, you get what I'm saying, because you're first generation here or whatever, you still grew up in Guam seeing the struggle that is way different than here.
Yeah.
Or like when we go to Mexico and visit our families or live there. That's why I tell all the time on podcasts, kids that never lived in Mexico and are all patriotic, never lived in Mexico.
Yeah.
So they're like, fuck America, I'm Mexican. But
yeah, never got that.
You've never lived there, bitch. Like, what are you talking
We're talking about Mexico.
Mexico. Not cool TJ and Revolution. Yeah. I'm talking about a ranch.
Ranchero style. Yeah. Like your own eggs up here.
Yeah. Like we were saying when you went to Sonora.
Ranchero style.
Yeah, fucking killing animals.
And pasturing the cow, you know. Yeah. All that chicken, you know, whatever. Feeding the pigs and the pig pet. Yeah, I did all that, you know. So.
Yeah.
You appreciate more, you know what I mean?
You know, so you just see that war mentality. But also now when you're in America and you grew up in bad circumstances, just not eating better than everybody, seeing kids have better shit than
earning,
you.
Earning that shit, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Like, a lot of things are handed to people.
Yeah, how about just like, you know, like...
Like Jamey got everything handed. Not at that gym.
I do have iPhone charger. Okay. Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? So, you want to put it in that sense of like finding the drive.
I think there's one in Michigan back here.
Because not everyone has patriotic drive, but you can have any other drive. Yeah. Just success, wanting to be the best. You have every type of drive eventually. You know what I'm saying? Like you want to have that drive to get there. Yeah. But like Herm, myself, and other people that grew up that way, like where you grew up in a certain country, now you want to like. Fuck, I'm fighting for this shit because they don't have nothing and I'm gonna be the motherfucker that gets
put it
here,
out there,
and I'm gonna be that dude and you wanna like for Mexico it's hard because I mean we have a gazillion legends.
Yeah, I was gonna say, man, damn, you guys doing it.
Yeah, we get Mexico, we get it.
I don't wanna boxing, we know that.
Yeah. So my goal is now to be a successful Mexican business owner that does shit and does different in the same sport.
Yeah.
Like Jolene, my fighter, she's getting inducted into the Hall of Fame in April.
Nice.
Wow. That's
you know what I mean? So
that's huge.
I got the opportunity that I'm presenting her.
Yeah.
So the committee got me to present her. And when we were talking, like, I didn't start her career, but what she said was like, you got me through a different era, a harder era of my career. I got her 3 world title shots.
Yeah.
3 of this. Saying at my age, being 30 when we first started, 30 fucking in my 20s when we first started, and still being having the balls to go up to promoters and be like, no, this is how it's going to be done. Or negotiating fights. I was like, fuck this, man. No, we're going to do it this way. And she could vouch in Mexico. I was like, we could leave, bitch.
Yeah.
They weren't trying to do something. I was like, cool, we don't got to fight. And I was like, let's go. And we started walking away. And they were like, what the fuck is happening?
Yeah.
I was like, look, bitch, I don't care. I'm not from here. You just gave us an awesome trip. We go back. Bitch.
Yeah. You gave us a vacation?
Grab some food on the way out, though. At least, you know what
I'm saying? Yeah. Drink a couple of these.
But you have to stand your ground, too. You got to stand your ground in that shit. And, and that's what's got me different shit and different, like, when everybody talks about, oh, you got lucky with Bolivita. Yeah, but it's been 2 years, bitch, and he's still here.
Yeah.
I still train him.
It's still
been 2 years, and he's still with
me. Well, obviously.
Like, what's that say about you? It's
he
like,
could have chosen
like, he is a world, he is a fucking killer
he's a
fighter.
World-class
and he
fighter.
Chose me. Out of all people he could choose, he chose me.
There's a connection there, you know? There's a trust.
But I earned it. I had to earn it with my work, with my pad work, with my knowledge of boxing.
Yeah, you can't just talk.
It wasn't him just like, oh, cool, you're cool.
Yeah.
You have a beard. I'm chill with you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? All my fighters, I've earned my trust with my pad.
Yeah, you didn't just sell them on words.
Yeah, like I have to put in
through.
The fucking work. I have to sit here with them. And even now, like I have to put extra work. I'm not getting paid extra for all the contract shit we're trying to deal with and all the shit we're doing.
Yeah, that's the stuff in the backseat.
It's where he sees and he respects that I'm grinding to get him out of bad situations. That I'm putting in the work. And he's like, okay, this is a motherfucker I could trust.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So that's why I tell people, when he wins his world title, I'm going to have a female world champion and a male world champion at 34. I'll be the youngest in San Diego's history to do it.
Yeah.
But I worked for it. Just like you worked for the shit and having all these guys come up under you.
Yeah.
You took lumps from these motherfuckers. They've punched you in the face. Well, you just punched me in the face.
And now they're getting better. And they're starting to put it on me too. You know what I mean? For me, that's a compliment.
It's like you look at it as like a lineage, like you're passing down something, you know?
Definitely.
It's like you want your product to be better than you, so that way his product will be better than him, and so
on.
Getting
better.
And that's what I tell these motherfuckers all the time.
You don't be prideful. I hate it when people are all like,
that's the goal, is to convince.
That's why I said, like, the coach that tries to put himself as the best or whatever, never, you're hurting the person. You're still
keeping them down. Or what's worse is that that like you they do something good and you fucking punish them for it, you know?
Yeah.
And it's like in their head, like, oh, I can't hit Coach hard because like
I don't want to piss him off again.
And
that's what I do with them when I tell them, like,
you should be happy. Like, yeah. Like, you know, if I fucking can't do something, like, that, fuck
that's
yeah,
just
that
like even,
hit.
You know, like, you know, John, you know, like he mentored me and we almost had to fight in the Bellator tournament. And they're like, oh, well, what do you think about that? And he's like, well, if we fight, you know, and he beats me, well, then I'm happy because then, you know, I coached a good thing, you know, like I did my job, you know what I mean? I was a good coach.
Yeah.
I brought up a real motherfucker, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But if I beat him, then kudos to me too, you know? Yeah. It's like, but no matter what, I win, you know? Like,
yeah.
I'm good with that.
Well,
that's how you should feel, you know?
Exactly.
You should be happy for your people to progress.
Yeah.
Always, man, you know?
Well, we had a situation like that with Bolivita because we go spar with Dennis Grachev at City. He's a good friend of mine, my old teammate. Bolly and him were sparring, but then they started becoming good friends, and his coach is my coach.
Yeah.
So that's a motherfucker that raised me as a fighter, as a man. Like, he was my, and then they offered us Gracho.
Yeah.
And I was fuck. And I was like very torn. Like, I was like, fuck. And I would talk to him, and he was a little torn because all like, you know, your coach is, because Vern is going to start helping me when Bolly fights for his world title. So it had a big thing, and I was like, I talked to Vern and I was like, and he told me, like, at the end of the day, it's a business.
Exactly.
Right? You gotta take the fight that fights.
We can still be friends.
Because he said the same shit. Like, if you beat me, I made a quality guy.
Yeah.
Right? He outthought me. That's the point.
Yeah.
So, it validates him as a coach.
So,
too,
as a coach.
Right?
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So he was like, cool, if you beat me. The whole point of him telling us, like, where he took us was for us to be better than him, for us to continue his lineage. And that's what I always do. Like other motherfuckers don't. Like, and I put his name on blast. Like, Ralph. Yeah. Ralph the Mouth? Wow. Vern trained you, motherfucker. Let's be real. Like, Vern trained you from the get-go. But you want to sit here and say, oh, Roger Mayweather, because you went up there for a fucking year, a few months? Like, respect the motherfucker that was there from day one, motherfucker. He not might be your coach no more.
Yeah.
But don't disrespect and not show the
from.
Love.
Yeah.
Like,
I always
keep the room strong.
Everywhere I'm at, Vernon Lee. Because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here.
Yeah.
So, whatever. Even if I trained with bigger name coaches before him.
Yeah.
But this motherfucker put me somewhere where no one else did.
Yeah.
True.
So you gotta respect.
Evolved you and mentored you, you know, like I had that, you know what I mean? Like I say, you know, like goes from Baroni to John.
Yeah.
And, you know, John mentored me. He taught me a lot about the sport, you know,
yeah.
How to know my worth, how to train, how to diet properly, everything, you know?
Everything.
And like, that's why, like, I got that from him, and then, you know, I kind of developed my own style, and I was crazy as that fucking guy.
He's an off the top.
That's crazy.
You know,
just a disclaimer.
Yeah.
If you motherfuckers don't know Herm, what he just said is scary as fuck. He said he's the calm version of that. Like, what?
But the tenacity in the cage is different, you know? Yeah, that I'm 100%. But like, you know, outside is a little different, you know? Whatever, you know?
Yeah. Some scary shit.
You know what I mean? Like, I'm a pit bull too, though, you know? Like, but... It's like you want to pass on something better, you know what I mean? It's always getting better, you know?
Yeah.
It's getting funneled down, but you want to keep the roots of it.
Yeah.
You know, that's again, the roots, you know what I mean? Like the heart. You know what I mean? Like the fucking fight anyone, anytime, fucking let's go, motherfucker. I don't care, we're going to fucking do this. You know what I mean? Punch for punch, you know what I mean? Whatever.
It's not just about what you can do in this sport, it's also about what you're going to leave behind when you're done with
right.
it.
Right, that's what I say. It depends on what you're in it for. You know, like me, like, money's good. Of course, I like money. Who the fuck doesn't?
You know
what I'm saying? I would like to get paid. But at the end of the day, when I go in there, the real me is going to show. You know what I mean? Like, I can hit pads and do all the fucking fancy work and train with the best guys or whatever, but the real me is like, I'm going to fucking bring the fight to you. I'm going to try to fuck you up.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to get fucked up doing it. If I make a mistake and then whatever, but I'm going to give everything to the last fucking breath. You know what I mean? Like, and I've showed that in my fights before. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think, at least, you know, like, they're wars. You know what I mean? I try to make it war because that's how I fight. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, it is what it is, you know?
Where did the game bread come from? Like, the game bread
thing, that's like, it stemmed from Phil Broney and War Machine, you know? Like, they started that thing, like, Broney has it tattooed on his lower back and War Machine has it tattooed on his forearm like I do, you know? And it's, again, it's the lineages, you know? Like, Coleman to Phil Broney, then Phil Broney mentored War Machine. And, you know, he mentored me and brought me up.
Yeah.
Just the good parts. You know, like, and, you know, I brought Nick up in the sport, you know, from like a high school kid.
Yeah.
You know, and then he has it too, you know. So it's not a cult thing or whatever, but the whole emphasis behind it is just like giving it everything you got, having heart, you know.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't matter, not only in fighting, you know, in anything you do. being a father, be game. Yeah. You know, because, give it everything you got, give it 100%, be the best you can. But never quit, never surrender. Give it everything you got to the last dying breath. You know what I mean?
Because we come from a ranch life, so game break could be from the fighting.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I don't know what's up with that.
The
roosters?
Yeah. Roosters.
I was asking my game break shirts, like, are you like a gamer or something?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
But they only
kind of, when your hair gets a little too hot.
They're like, hey, so are you like super into gaming? I'm like, no, like gamer, I'm like,
but they only ask him that because when I'm in the game pressure, either I'm fighting or I have fighting dogs.
Yeah,
because
there's
a fighting dog term too, like game bred dogs.
Yeah, exactly. That's
you're like bred for a game.
Game, you know. Like, there's no quit. You know what I mean? There's no quit.
Fucking Jamey. God damn it, Jamey. You have no tough stories. All someone told me I was a gamer. Really?
No, it doesn't happen once. Multiple times.
Because when I was a gamer and shit, when I was a sweater.
I'm going to do some soft shit like I'm eating a cookie or something.
Fuck, man.
They're doing the cool. I'm just going to eat a cookie and answer my game.
Yeah. So,
you're
a gamer? Yeah. Well, no, like coming from that, like you said, just that lineage, passing down that name, whatever. It
stems from the...
It's a mindset, basically, that you're passing down.
And the coaching aspect is like... Like we said before, you know, like me and War, we almost had to fight, but our agreement was like, hey, if we fight, it's gonna be in the finals, and then, you know, it doesn't matter, we're gonna train together still, like we were training, and we're gonna fucking go. That night's gonna be, the only thing different is, we don't stop until someone tells us to stop.
Yeah.
You know, and we're good with that, you know, whatever. Just like Nick's my student, but now he's my teammate, you know? Like, if we had to fight, we agreed, like, it would only be for a title or something, you know? Like,
something
it would,
meaningful.
Well, exactly, something worthwhile.
If it was going to take one of us to the next era level of our career, you know what I mean? Then let's fucking do it. But we're going to train together, and we're going to go in there that night, and we're going to give everything we fucking got, and at the end of the day, I'm going to fucking love them the same, you know? Probably more.
Because you'll see people who, like, fight, and they're like, oh, we have to separate each other.
Examples like the TJ Dillashaw situation, you know? Like, and the United Favor situation, you know what I mean? Like,
but those fuckers don't like each other no more,
right? Yeah, because they let that shit get to them, you know? Exactly. Like, they took it personally.
Exactly. What also is, like we were saying before, like, when you bring certain coaches or certain people and then motherfuckers start talking purdy and start taking fighters and start taking...
Yeah.
And it gets real personal that way because that's the reason, like I said, like, I would be at Undisputed more, but a few people said some shit that got personal.
Yeah.
That's why, to me, that was personal. You guys were never personal, never said nothing personal about me, but the shit that was said there by certain people was personal. So now I can't go there to go see my friends because that personal shit, the way we grew up, that drive's gonna bring me to a whole nother place.
Yeah.
That's your business. That's not my business. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. So
that's how I live life. That's how I live life.
So
it's like,
out of respect.
If it doesn't involve me, I don't really give a fuck.
The facility,
you know? That's how I go about my
based
life.
Based on the shit that if we were fam, right? We were all supposed to be fam. And I said, hey, just don't do this. And someone does it. You feel the disrespect.
Yeah.
Even if you were close. If someone, if you say, you told him and you have to go somewhere in the camp and all you said was, hey man, don't talk shit about me, don't badmouth me, let's just keep it 100. And then you're hearing them say it.
Yeah.
It's gonna get personal.
It hurts, you know,
because
it hurts.
Exactly, because you feel like this used to be my people's.
Yeah.
I've told you personal shit about my life. I've been there with you guys. And then you start taking
in this
personal
world, in the politics part, I try not to get involved in it anymore, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Like,
I try to keep mutual ground, you know, because we're all in it for the same goal.
Exactly.
And we all want to live, make a living. Yeah. We all want to do what we want to do. And we're all out there for the same goal, I guess.
Yeah.
You
know? And we got to understand, too, is that people have, like, you know, people, you got to respect someone. Like, people go their separate ways sometimes, you know?
Yeah.
Like, they have their own thoughts of, like, hey, man, I'm kind of thinking of going this way. It's just a certain way how you go about it.
So, like, my thing is,
there's a fire burning, it's who throws the gas first.
Yeah.
It's like we said last time, like, I have a problem with person, not with the gym. So I still shout out Undisputed. I still send people to Undisputed because I don't have a problem with Undisputed. Undisputed's all of y'all. That'd be saying me I have a problem with all of y'all.
Yeah.
So I don't have a problem with Undisputed or with the coaching staff because we're cool. Me and you chop it down.
Yeah.
You like my shit. We chop it down.
Yeah.
I don't chop it down too much with Jamey, but we have it. No, I'm just saying, we have it.
God damn.
No, I'm just saying, we have it too much. No, how many times do we talk? Like twice, motherfucker.
Cabron.
I talk with these motherfuckers more. That's all I'm saying. Like, I still talk like, what up, motherfucker? Or like, you know, like, hey, bitch. Like some of that. Like, you know, but we don't talk like I talk with them too. You know what I'm saying? But to me, it was just, learning experience. That's how I'm taking it. Like, yeah. It's just learning. So now how I run my shit, how I run my stuff is going to be determined on how I am.
Right.
The shit I learned from you, the shit. Because I learn stuff from every person I train with or anything. Just saying, just observing you, coach.
That's a good coach, man. Yeah. I learned always willing to learn from anybody. You know, from
yeah. coaching, and from anything too. Yeah. You know, like we're talking about Barrett, how Barrett likes watching like bug fights.
Oh yeah.
You know, but it's like think about it. Like I bet he's learning some shit. You know how bugs like you know move.
What do I do? I'm
like,
this one watches all these like animal
fights.
Yeah,
like,
that's what I'm saying.
And
yeah.
shit. Like
what's up here?
Yeah. I watch that shit because it's like, damn, how do you move like that?
Yeah, like, think about like a dog. Think about a dog. If you're trying to fucking, like, you know, wrestle with a fucking pit bull,
and
like,
it gets
just
around.
Strong, like, how they move. Yeah, you know?
This one's like, look at this bear. Look at this bear.
Yeah.
Like, they do
he shows
shit.
Me, like, kangaroos, fucking yeah. choking kangaroos out of
yeah.
like,
yeah.
I mean, kangaroos.
Yeah. Shit.
Did like, you guys see that?
Smack the butt. Yeah, I love that
yeah,
video.
That shit.
I love that video.
Yeah. He got lucky that kangaroo didn't fuck him
kangaroos
up.
Are fucking, yeah, you see, like, kangaroos have like, sharp ass fucking like claws, you know? So
yeah,
like, that thing
really
fucked him up.
I've never seen one like in the zoo. I've only seen on TV.
Yeah, bro, they got fucking dope.
They have claws.
Yeah.
I thought they had like hoofs.
No, they have like these
yeah.
fucking claws
oh,
on the bottom.
Mean ass really? Fucking claws.
So the reason they stand on their tail and kick you is to claw you, to pull you open.
That's like a velociraptor.
Yeah, dude, they'll fuck you up.
You know they choke out. Other kangaroos.
Yeah, you seen that video? Yeah.
No, no, they constantly do that. That's
yeah.
a method of
that's what he's doing. That's what he's trying to do the
dog. To the
dog,
yeah. They try to choke you out to kill you.
It's crazy.
Australia's like, fuck that. Not my dog, not today, mate. Not today, mate.
I thought they had like hooves.
No, they have
claws. Oh, yeah.
That's scary, man.
Yeah, dude.
But that's what I'm saying.
It looks strong, man.
As much as we're tough and we all fight, let them put you butt-ass naked in the woods.
Yeah.
Yeah, someone talked about it once before. I was like hearing that. It's like, we as an animal, we're not like that durable of a fucking animal.
Oh,
yeah,
dude.
We're like,
I think
oh,
Bill Burr.
Oh,
I think it's Bill Burr. One of the comedians said it. Like, he was like, a fucking
thing.
Squirrel. A squirrel come up and fucking
and fuck you up. Like, we fucking go out like, with anything. A fly. Look how panicked we get with a bee and shit.
Yeah.
Like,
spider comes down your face.
Oh, shit. Yeah, for sure. Spider.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, I'm not supposed to win. I'm like, hey, oh, shit. That little fucking bite you once. And
yeah.
Like, oh, I don't like. I don't like rats.
Coach don't like rats.
I hate rats. Yo, that's
why. Isn't that weird though? But why?
Like, I don't even get it.
It's a
trip.
Has it ever done anything to us?
Yeah.
Dude, and I fucking
hate that pimple.
Yeah. Like, I have pimples.
Oh, fuck that shit. Get the room and smash that shit. You know what I mean? Like,
I'm scared of those shits. I don't even want to touch them.
It's so
funny. But I don't like snakes, man.
But I have pimples, bro. Like,
I don't like
snakes. My dog can easily break my fucking hand.
Yeah.
Easily. He's 95 pounds. With a head about this big, easily fucking break my hand. And I have no problem just grabbing him and tossing him when I'm pissed.
Yeah.
But let me see a motherfucking rat.
Yeah.
I've told everybody, fuck around and bring a rat thinking it's funny. I'm gonna shoot you in the leg. I've shown him the guns. I was like, I'm gonna shoot you in the fucking leg. I'm just warning you, I don't play that shit.
Yeah.
I punch my sister.
I punch my sister.
I punch my mom in the face if she come with a rat. I don't fuck with no rats, man. Like, why would you think someone's fear is funny? I'm fucking you up. I'm gonna shoot you in the leg. Have I not shown you guys the guns?
Yeah.
Have I not shown you the guns?
I'm gonna shoot you in the leg.
We've been warned.
Because I said that once. I was like, oh, I'm scared of rats. And you can see every mind working. Like, ooh, like a fucking
really,
coach.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, look, motherfucker. I went in there, got my AR, and then got that. I was like, I will shoot you in the fucking leg. Do not fuck with me. I will fucking shoot. I'm not gonna kill you.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna fuck your leg up. Like, I don't fuck with that. Like, there's something everyone's scared of. It is weird. Like, people are scared of spiders, and you said snake. I have
like
no
snakes,
fear
man.
Of snakes.
Yeah.
Like, I've grabbed a rattlesnake and
chopped
those
fucking things, man. Yeah.
But you see what I'm saying? Like, there's something that fucks with you. Like, which is weird, right? Because, like, I can easily just on size, I can go and fuck up a rat.
Yeah.
Just. Fuck that, move fast.
Yeah, got underneath. Yeah, I don't know.
Fuck that. Like,
on the side of them.
I heard one in the wall in the room.
I think just because they're dirty and shit, you know. Like,
yeah, they got like disease.
Yeah, they got diseases. Yeah, they fester quick. You know, like,
that's how the plague started. Yeah.
Like,
bubonic plague.
Yeah.
Well, the rats are all in the other side of the house because on my side of the house, I have the dogs.
Yeah.
And they're outside. So
there's
no rats on my side. As soon as I go to the other side of the house, fuck this. Man, I just come right back. I'm like, no, I'm good.
You're calling the
floor. Like, you just hear them. They'll they crawl through the electrical wires
from conduits.
Like all that shit, dude. They're like, they're just walking through it all chill. Like,
we just going to call the exterminator.
Dad, I got that dog. Yeah. My female dog is a game bred dog. Yeah, like, she fucking hunts and she grabs and shit. All like shaking. Apart. Like she doesn't care. She's like just constantly pacing.
Yeah.
Cause she has, and she's like a game bred pit bull. Like nice. My male just lays down. And Canelo just lays there.
Chilling,
I just fall asleep.
Yeah.
Like, fuck, are you supposed to protect me, bitch? That's what I got you for. Yeah,
not right now.
Like, I'm fucking be sleeping and
catching
shit.
Catching
this nap. And do you ever think of doing any other fucking sport? Like, just pure boxing? Would you attempt to do a boxing?
I would like to switch over to kickboxing eventually. Like, pure kickboxing. I love Glory. I like love watching Glory. And I think it'd be sick to just get in there and, you know, mix up with those guys.
Yeah.
But... other than that, I would like, it's not even like a fighting sport, but I think I'd fucking love to do rugby.
Rugby?
I like watching rugby. I think that shit looks so hard. I'm like, dude.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
Brutal, man.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
ever, huge.
Man. Yeah, if it gets to the point where I can't fight anymore, like, I'm probably going to try to do rugby because that shit looks, I love those, you know.
I've had 5 amateur fights.
And 4 pro?
No, actually, I guess 8 fights. No, I've had 5 amateur fights. And
3 pro?
And I was supposed to have a fight March 18th.
Nice.
So.
Oh, yeah, you got some
moves,
and you're just like waiting for.
Yeah, hopefully my manager Brian Hamper is getting something going for me.
Nice.
Sucker Punch Entertainment. We'll see what the new year brings in for
Do you feel that the UFC buying everything out kind of fucked up MMA a bit?
No,
not at all.
I feel like it's making it more. It's like just like it's the monopolizing it, you know. So it's becoming like you either do what we say.
Showing true colors. Yeah. Showing true colors. How they favor certain people. How they let people get away with stuff.
You know what the thing I do like is that. When you make it to the UFC, you quote unquote made it to the UFC, right?
Yeah.
Like you made it to the top of top.
Yeah, you think you made it.
Right? I'm not saying that all the top fighters are there.
Yeah.
But primarily some of the best are.
Yeah, because it's the most talked about organization.
It's like
so.
The NFL, you know?
See, in a way, that's where it fucks it up for boxing because we don't have like one organization.
Yeah.
We just so everywhere that a fucking paper champ because of his record and shit could have a belt. And then all of a sudden he fights a real dude and just blah, gets slept.
Yeah.
So there's like nowhere to gauge. We gauge people on who's on TV more. People are like, oh, he's the best because he's on TV. But like, that doesn't necessarily mean that.
Yeah.
Like, because no one knew who the fuck Chocolatito was until he started getting on TV.
Yeah.
Then everybody's like, oh, he's pound for pound. But this motherfucker was like,
he's been
40 and no motherfucker.
Yeah,
like, beating up top motherfuckers in multiple weight classes.
But now you saw him.
But now that you saw him on TV, now it's like, oh, shit, this motherfucker's pound for pound. Or when they, you know, like, the assumption of people without credentials, I always tell them, you have an opinion. But there's not much credibility behind your opinion. You can still have it. You can believe it all you fucking want. But when you go to a job, I always say this shit. When you go to a job, you don't go with a blank piece of paper. You go with a resume that has credentials, that has experience to give you that fucking job.
Yep.
So when a motherfucker argues...
Qualifications.
Yeah, like, and argues with you like, no, this motherfucker did this and this was this. And you kind of just have to go, okay.
Yeah.
I don't sit there and like... Because I try to explain to him, like, look, man, boxing is a business now. It's like a full-fledged business. We're like, oh, well, the best weren't fighting the best, and the best were fighting the best back in the 80s and shit. Yeah, but the Marvin Hagler and Leonard fought took 7 years, too.
Yeah.
Before that fight ever happened. Like, there's always been politics in anything that makes fucking money, period.
For sure. Mm-hmm.
There's always been money. So if there's money involved, it's going to, like you said, it's who you know. What type of, you know what I'm saying? Like
what you're bringing to the table.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Like a lot of the, like, the more good-looking cats get pushed up that's because...
I went to the Ultimate Fighter tryouts and the Pelagian, he was, like, the producer for the show, you know, when I tried out for, like, 2010, whatever. And I made it to, like, the interviews, you know, and he's like, first off, I don't give a fuck if you're 20, you know, and you beat the fucking UFC champ. It don't fucking mean shit to me. He's like, are you good-looking? You know, do you have personality?
Because
if
TV
you don't
show.
Have those things, you might as well walk the fuck out of the door.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
No one
really?
Cares to watch a boring motherfucker. You know what I mean? He's like, and if you're Canadian, you got 10 points against you already.
Yeah.
I was like, everyone's like, what? They're like, yeah, because GSP, he always says, yes, no, okay, I'm ready. Let's fight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He's like, no one cares about that. We know you're going to fucking fight. It's a fight, motherfucker. Tell us why you're fighting. Tell us what you're going to do.
Like,
you know?
That's so big.
Exactly.
That just shows right there. You know what I mean? Like,
yep.
what's behind it, you know?
Because, I mean, that fucking Conor shit was fast.
Yeah.
That motherfucker got to the fast.
Yeah. Like, yeah, but he also backed it up, too. Yeah,
exactly.
You know, and he backed it up. He earned his weight, yeah. You know?
Can't you know what it was?
At first, I was like, fuck this dude. You know, he's talking all this
but
shit.
You know, I always like this. Since we were
yeah, I know.
I just like shit talking.
But then he backs it up, and you're like, all right, you know.
I didn't, you know, because like, I think the old school way, I'm like, fuck,
I beat you out of bed. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I paid that bet. Come on, hey, I'm honest. I keep to my word.
Yeah, I
it's like I looked at it the old school style, like I was brought up, you know, like if you talk shit like that in the gym,
you're gonna get your ass beat.
You ain't gonna fucking talk like that ever again, I promise you.
Yeah.
Like if you're gonna
fucking
gym,
learn, yeah.
Like you're gonna get shut the fuck up right then and there, you know, and I guarantee you'll change the way you think, you know?
Yeah.
That's all. That's why I thought about it like that. But then when he came up and he started doing his shit, I was like, fuck, man.
He's really
well, can back it up. I guess he can talk like that, you know what I mean?
Like the first time I was like, okay, maybe he got lucky.
Yeah.
You know, the podcast again, I was like, okay.
Everybody.
And then again and again, I'm like, oh fuck, it's not a fluke.
Well, because, like, I didn't really study him and see where he came from and what he went
through.
You look at Aldo, you see he's from, like, the slums of Brazil. And, like, he had a rough growing up. And he fought in the small shows in Brazil, like, tough fights. Like, you see him, if you watch
that,
his old fights, he's wearing, like, the same shorts and three fights in a row.
Yeah.
Because he probably doesn't have any sponsors to get him through, you know, to get him new shorts. But he's, like, he's fighting, he has the same fucking shorts, you know what I mean? Like, that just shows, like, damn, you know?
Yeah.
Like, so it's like, fuck, I grew up that style, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't have no sponsors, you know what I mean, or anything, like, coming up in my early fights. I had tough fights.
Yeah.
And it's like, fuck, so I'm with that guy because I can relate, you know, but I didn't realize... Where
Tony did the same shit?
Yeah, exactly. You know, it was a warfare and shit.
Yeah.
I didn't do a background check. I kind of judged
all the judged way quick, and I
you know,
do that all the time.
I'm guilty of that, and I admit that. I judged, like, man, who the fuck's this white boy? Fucking Howley guy, you know what I mean? He got lucky on the Dustin Poirier fight, and now he's gonna fight the champ already. What the fuck? Like, you know what I mean? Put it on him, Aldo. You know what I mean? Show him what's
that's
up.
That's not singing, you know?
And you grew up in the old school dungeon, too. You know, fuck this guy.
Aldo got fucked.
That's
so mental.
You know what I mean?
He got into that mental shit with Aldo.
Yeah.
Too much. He fucked with that motherfucker hard. I was like, damn.
And that's the strongest thing that you
have. And he's really good at that, too.
That's the strongest thing you have going into the fight. You know what I mean? Like, it's your mind. Because
he did that shit to...
Like, in Muhammad Ali, he never attacked people physically. He always attacked their mind.
Because he did that shit to Eddie. Eddie tried to play it off, but you could tell he was acting like...
Yeah.
He was acting...
Connor's fucking sick.
Like Connor got in that motherfucker.
He's good at that. He's good at that game.
Taking it,
He's fucking witty with him. He's quick with the comeback.
So hard when people try to roast him back.
Dude, I still can't believe the fucking press conference.
With Jeremy Stevens? Like, who the fuck is that
guy? That's the best fucking. I loved it.
Like,
I was like, that's so fucking funny.
Ever, yo.
Like, and the whole panel was like, goddamn. Like, I was like, even though he didn't want to laugh, just gotta like
fuck, give it the head down. With that shit. Like, that was dope. Yeah. I like him because he's a southpaw.
Oh, what's up, Max Griffin? Come down and train with us, man. Check us out. Always welcome, man. What's up?
Oh, what do you say?
Sit down in SoCal. What's up?
Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we got a lot. But, yeah, that's why I like him. He's a southpaw because I like fighters that can talk this shit and then go do it. Like, that are not scared to just say, oh, yeah, we'll see what happens.
And it's like, one of those things, too, where
I just like that.
While it's happening, you know, you kind of don't appreciate it. But I bet after he retires and he gets old, the younger kids are going to look back on it.
Yeah.
And they'll start relating him to, like, Muhammad Ali. Because you look at Muhammad Ali, that motherfucker talks so much shit.
Yeah, but he's great, man.
Yeah,
great.
You know, and he backed it up. Same thing with Conor. Like, he's talking shit
and
he's backing
it
up.
He went out and he battled, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He still battled.
Yeah.
And he paid for it later in his career, you see, you know what I mean?
Oh, of course,
The damage, you know?
And that's what, like, I tell people all the time when they're like, oh, I don't care about the technique, and I like to see fights. I'm like, but when these fuckers retire and can't speak, you're not there supporting them either. Motherfucker, you're not there.
Are you still going to come and hang out with me when I'm fucking...
You'll know I know Mexican fighters. Like, there's a Mexican fighter that comes in the trolley and works at a fucking store here, man. Like, you're a five-time world champion, motherfucker. Why are you what?
Yeah.
Like, you taking the trolley... Like, I know you're not being environmentally.
Yeah, I can't drive anymore. My hands don't.
That when he talks to you, you can't understand.
My hands can't stop doing this. So.
And it just fucking sucks to see that because then everybody was bigging him up when he was in the shit. You know, I know it's a fighter's choice to do it.
Yeah.
But also, like, don't make these motherfuckers murder themselves like that. Like, yeah. Fuck, yo. Like,
you know, you're kind of like, it's like you're racing a horse. You're fucking, like, just fucking pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing.
Yeah.
And you're not thinking about when that fucking horse breaks its leg, you know, and like, oh, you got to put like, it down now.
Like, I feel you need both sides. You need the Floyds and Connors, and then you need the tough, quiet guys that beat everybody the fuck up. You need, like I said, that balance.
You need that balance. Both worlds.
Because
you need to play it smart. You need to fight a smart game, but you also want to bring it.
Like, Dos Anjos and all those motherfuckers. You like fighters like that that just kind of say two words and then go in there and then they're fucking savage.
Do their business,
yeah.
You know what I mean? Like I like Cowboy. Cowboy Cerrone is probably my favorite MMA fighter.
Oh, he's game, man.
I just like he'll fight anybody.
That's gonna be a good fight. Him and Masvidal, man. You know what I mean?
And
I like them both.
He does whatever he wants. Like, he's never really seen the whole, like, he drinks beer when he wants. He does crazy shit.
Boy, he's a real fighter.
But he lives his life. You know what I'm saying?
Like, he's not worried. He knows. He's like, it's no big deal. He's not stressing, like, well, I gotta take all these supplements. Yeah. Well, I gotta do this and that.
Yeah.
No, he's like, Fight day, I'm gonna do what I do, you know what I mean? Like, he's one of my favorite guys.
Like, I watch
He's real as fuck, dude. I love Cerrone.
Yeah, he's one of my favorite guys.
The video that, you know, he's talking about leading up to a fight. Example. It's real as fuck. Like, that's probably one of the first people who fucking admits it. Like, I'm scared as fuck, you know?
Yeah. Like you said, like, you won't know until you're the one there. Yeah. You know, you have to be a fighter to experience it, you know?
Yeah.
And that's what I'll tell them. I was like, just because in sparring we're not showing fear doesn't mean that in an event you're not showing fear. You're scared.
Oh, it's totally
scared as fuck. Yeah.
Totally different.
I'm always fucking nervous.
It's a scary.
I'm fucking nervous.
But tell me.
You know, if everyone says they're not, they're fucking lying.
I'm nervous as fuck.
Like,
because if you're not nervous, then you just really don't care. Like,
well, that's the
thing. If you're passionate about something, you're going to care about it. Yeah.
Like, the reason why you get nervous is if you really gave everything you had to prepare for it, and you're really going to go out there and give everything you got.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And at the end result is not so much getting hurt. That's fucking, who cares about that?
Whatever.
Yeah. It's the failure of
your hard work not showing its success.
Yeah.
I think that's what it is. Because
you know you fucking got like, oh,
yeah,
it's,
well, you
fuck
got all the pressure of like, everyone's watching, your family, everyone's watching, and like,
In their mind,
you're a fucking monster. You know what I mean? Because like, they don't do what you do.
Yeah.
You know, they go to work and they do what they do, and they're like, oh, he's the fucking best. He, you know what I mean? He's gonna fuck you up. You're like, hey, man.
What happened, man?
I got it, bro.
Your gym will support you. Your gym will back you so much.
Yeah.
That blindly you'll support.
Like, yeah.
We have this whole like tribal shit of like, that's our group, that's our team. So we blindly see like realistic shit. Like, me as a coach, like I was telling you, like, I get nervous for my fucking fighters. Me when I was a fighter, even though I was an amateur fighter, still, like, I did a shitload of amateur fights. And the few times that I wasn't nervous, I lost. Like, real shit. Like, when I was just like,
he's going there flat. You know,
whatever.
Flat,
like, I didn't have that fight or flight type scenario no more.
Yeah.
Well, I think there's always gotta be fear.
Fear, absolutely. Yeah.
There's always fear involved. I don't care what anyone says. I'm not saying like scared. Like I said again, to be hurt or whatever, but there's that fear of failing for certain reasons.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, for me, it's like, I got my whole school that I'm representing. I got my island I'm representing. I got my team and everyone and my family and my friends. They're, you know, expecting a certain outcome. So I'm going to do everything in my power to make sure the outcome is good. And if not, I'm going to give everything I had to make sure I did the best I can to get a good outcome, win or lose. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, like I posted yesterday, you know, like when I go out there to fight, I go out there to fight. I'm not in there like, let me get this fucking takedown and hold him out. Now I'm going in there doing what I do.
Yeah.
I'm going to take some punishment. I'm going to give some punishment. And like I said, I might fucking lose. But I'll tell you what, ain't gonna be a fucking easy.
He's gonna remember you.
And you're gonna remember like, fuck, bro, that guy Herman's all, god damn, I'm over stuff. Because you can ask all the top guys that fought me how it was fighting me. You know what I mean? They'll be like, god damn, the fucker's head is hard. You know what I mean? Like, fuck, you know what I mean? Exactly. You know, I'm like, and for me, I'll be happy with that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And if they want to do it again, let's fucking do it. I'm game and I'm always fucking ready. You know what I mean? I'm happy to oblige that. You know what I mean? And give you what you want. You know, that's just my mentality and mindset. like, you know, the Yamato Mashi way, you know, like, I'm in there to fucking die for real, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And a lot of guys, the newer generation say it, but then, like, they get in the choke, like,
not about
this,
it. Yeah.
Look at the Sage Northcutt guy, you know, like, you got a little bit of the choke, he's like, oh, fuck, okay, I'm out, you know what I mean? Like, I'm settled with my show win money, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, no, fuck you, motherfucker, I don't care about the money, now it's about my fucking pride, you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
I'm
gonna yeah.
die in this bitch, you know?
Yeah.
Like, there's a rep, there's a stop, yeah, well, fuck, oh, shit, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like Hollywood
is fucking sick, yeah. you know?
I'm gonna go to sleep, you know what I mean, and that's the difference. I have that mindset but I don't know until I get choked, so I'm not gonna put myself in that scenario.
It goes back to that ultimate, to like Ensign, you know, he's fucking like in his book he was talking about, he's like, you're a fighter, it's your job to fight, it's not your job to like stop the fight, you know, that's the ref, if he sees like, right. something, then he'll be the one to stop it.
Yeah,
you know, that's intense, that's an intense way to think about it, you know, that's yeah. why I'm like, that motherfucker will let you break his arm, he's like, I'm not tapping, it's not my job to tap, so I'm gonna fucking keep fighting, you
yeah,
know,
because the last fucking match, yeah, yeah. you know what I mean? Yeah.
And that's why I feel like the MMA guys need to get paid more, it's just because no one's really died in the sport doesn't mean it's not dangerous. Like,
yeah.
and you can die anytime.
Any
show, you sign a contract that says if you die,
yeah.
and they give you a substantial amount of money. Like, I remember when I fought in Bellator, like, it was $500,000. You know, like, if you die, and they have the percentage breakdowns, and me and one
yeah.
when I just told you, he's like, hey, man. He's like, sign yours to me, I'll sign my steel. You know what I mean? Like, but because they know, of course, you could die. And,
yeah.
And that's also another fear thing in the back of your mind. It should be, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it should be taken serious because not only can you die, but, hey, man, you catch one knee, one kick, one punch, and you're not the same, you know? Like,
look at fucking Cyborg. You know? Could have easily,
the
his
knee,
face
yo.
Was crushed, bro.
Yeah.
You could have easily just
fucked.
That could have been
the day,
it.
But at the end of the day, that's what we choose for ourselves.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what we choose. That's why I say, like, I always say, like, follow your dreams and follow your heart, you know, like, and whatever you want to do and whatever you believe. And some other people's always going to criticize you and be yep. a naysayer and say, hey, man, you're fucking dumb. What are you going to do when you're done fighting? You're gonna be fucking broke, you know,
yeah.
like, and broken. Hey, motherfucker, I'm not there yet. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
You know, I'll
let
worry
me
about
enjoy,
that when I get there.
Let me enjoy the ride right now.
Exactly.
I'm not worried about the fucking getting off the roller coaster.
Yeah.
I'm fucking trying
enjoying
to ride
the
this
ride.
Bitch.
Yeah.
You know
yeah.
what
like,
I mean?
You go ahead and hide in your cave till you're 50
and
you know,
and
see how much you enjoy
out,
your life.
I figured out.
Yeah.
This far, what I wanted to do, and I'm doing it. So when that time comes, I think I'll adjust.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I'm not fucking worried about that.
People are so worried about that they waste their whole life being
yeah,
afraid
like, I
of something.
Thinking
it's like, dude,
that's
fucking
smart.
Follow
yeah,
your fucking dream.
I'm for that. You know, think ahead. You know, for your future, whatever.
Yeah.
But tomorrow's not promised to anybody.
Yeah. yeah.
You know what I mean?
We can go out and get hit by a car.
I
want to know I enjoy
so
myself that day.
Do what you love, and to be successful or to be happy in your life. It's love what you do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's what
well,
I believe.
I think
if you don't love what you do, you're wasting your time, man.
Yeah.
The way I train guys like that, I prep them round like one round. No, like I can't train you for 12 rounds. I don't know what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
The fucking rest of the rounds. I gotta prep you what I think we can
right.
do. So I prep that round. Then by the second round, like I start analyzing. Like he trains for the fight. Like I don't want people to misunderstand that. But an extensive game plan is sometimes wrong because you don't know what this fucker's gonna do.
Yeah.
He could change it on you.
Oh yeah.
So you come prepared physically, mentally.
The best you can, you know.
That's
best all
you
yeah.
can
yeah.
to do.
Yeah.
That's all
and
you
now,
can do.
Now my job is to understand the scenarios that are happening so I can make the adjustments. Cause like you said, your job is to fight.
Yeah.
My job is to analyze
and well, yeah.
and make adjustments so you can improve the fight and win
yeah.
the fight. So when I take my shit and analyze, that's why I was telling him, I analyze everything. Because that my job is to analyze. Like I analyze weird ass animal videos and
yeah.
shit, but I'm always analyzing everything.
Yeah.
I analyze how people eat.
Well that's
how people
that,
train.
That's the thing that sucks in MMA that that's where the part of not being enough money comes in. That sucks. Because like, you know, you gotta balance a job because you gotta make ends meet still, you know?
Oh,
you know?
Yeah.
And you can't focus on fighting, you know, like
yeah.
if you could just focus on 100% of fighting, I think, then you'll be more successful. Obviously,
oh,
right?
Yeah.
That's hard, you know?
Yeah.
If you're single or whatever, who gives a fuck? Sleep on your buddy's couch. You know, like, hey, I'm gonna fucking sleep on your couch for the camp. I'll fucking do this fight. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm gonna make it through, like, fucking tuna out of the can and wheat bread if I have to. You know
yeah.
what I mean? Like, because I've done that, man. I've done those days, you know?
Yeah.
So, you know what I mean? It was tough. You know what I mean? But you do what you gotta do if you wanna follow your dreams. And there's gonna be suffering, you know, it's gonna
yeah.
suck.
Sacrifice.
You know what I mean?
Sacrifice.
But you gotta look at what's gonna happen at the end. You know what
yeah.
I mean? You're gonna get this
what's
temporary sacrifice
yeah.
for
yeah.
this small moment of glory,
what's
you know what I mean? And it's like a high, man. Like I've always said, like when you work your ass off and you train hard and you go in there and you go to war and you give that person everything you had and they give you everything they had and you come out on top,
oh, God,
the feeling you know, when you get your hand raised, it's that's crazy, what winning, man. Yeah. That high, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. It's like
when you know everything you did during camp, like everything you did during camp was fucking exactly what you needed for the fight. Oh, you're like, you oh, that's perfect.
And it gives you this like motivation to like train more. Yeah. I want to do it more. That's addictive.
You want more of it. You know, like, oh, I need that again. I need that again. You know, like, then that's why you live for it. That's why it's a lifestyle. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's not like a hobby, like, oh, I'm an MMA fighter. Like, man, shut the fuck up. You know what I mean? You're a dork. You're a fucking dork. You know what I mean? Yeah.
I don't see my shirt. I'm wearing fucking Affliction. Let's go. Like,
that's the thing where it's like,
I'm a fighter, man.
Yeah. That's why, like, okay. I haven't fought a serious fight since 2014. Yeah, I fought in small shows, but whatever. You know, like, I'm not disrespecting the organization or taking away from the fighters. But whatever, it's a small show. It's not like a fucking huge accomplishment. You know, like, if I'm not winning there, I should be fucking winning there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I say is like, I don't call myself a fighter right now because I'm not currently on the circuit. You know, I was a fighter. You know what I mean? But I'm not retired. Yeah. Meaning, like, I'm still open back in to take a fight. Yeah. You know what I mean? But I'm not retired. But at the same time, people are like, hey, man, you're a fighter. Like, no, I'm not a fighter. I fought, but I'm not a fighter right now, currently. I'm a trainer. You know what I mean? Because I don't fight to make ends meet right now. I'm not relying on that fucking fight purse paycheck or those sponsors to make ends meet right now at this time being. Yeah. But when I do get back on the circuit and people ask me, then I'll be like, yeah, I'm a fighter. You know what I mean? Like, there's like people that say, oh, I'm a model. Motherfucker, you pay to get your pictures taken.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Like,
yeah.
And you're over there like throwing them out. Like, you're not a model. You know what I mean? A model gets paid to model. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So don't say that. You know, like, there's guys that are like, if you're not on the circuit, if it's not paying your fucking bills,
if that's not your
then you
actual
shouldn't say
income,
that's what you are.
Exactly.
You know, that's not your
occupation.
And that's just the honest truth.
Yeah.
Like, you know? Do you have the fight in your heart? Yeah, I got the fucking fight in my heart. I'm ready to fight any fucking time, anywhere. Let's do this. But I'm not on the circuit.
Yeah.
I'm not making money off of that to support my family right now. So am I a fighter? Not right now.
Yeah, you feel
but
like
I fight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I fought. But if an opportunity presents itself, of course, I'll jump on it.
Yeah.
If everything's right, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then I'm back on the circuit, but are you a fighter? Yeah, I'm a fighter, man. I'm ready to go. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's how I look at it.
That's what I tell everybody. I'm like,
and you got to stay humble in that sense.
I'm a trainer. You know? I tell everybody I'm a trained fighter.
It's keeping yourself in check, really. It's not really for anyone else besides yourself. It's just understanding that, like, hey, man, you're not, you're not what you think you are. You know, you got to, like, acknowledge the fact that, like,
not now that you train and do all that shit now. When you see,
I think it's made me a lot better, honestly. Watching it these past couple of years from the outside and really seeing, you know, analyzing it a little bit more and helping my guys get ready for their fights and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I think it's made me a lot better.
Yeah.
You know, because you see the things that you don't really pay attention to when you're in it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, do you consider yourself a professional trainer?
Oh, for sure.
For sure, right?
100%. I've proven it. I've brought up professional fighters.
Right? Yeah.
You know, Nick, you know, I've had guys win titles. Ben Koshaba, you know what I mean? Professional titles under me, you know? Even amateur guys, they've won titles under me.
And that's where I tell people the difference, you know, because there could be...
But I brought these guys up from nothing, square. I mean, like, first fight.
Yeah,
like,
scratch.
From amateur to their first pro fight, I brought them up and all the way through.
This
know?
Is
so
my
thing,
like...
That's why,
I've done both. I've had Stalacia go from zero to Team USA. I've tried the same way. I think it's a lot harder, in my personal opinion, to get a made fighter.
Yeah, because you got to undo their habits or whatever. You know?
Yeah. It's so hard. Yeah. And so when people criticize, like, well, you didn't make them. And I was like, yeah, but you got to teach them new shit. You got to make this motherfucker that's
they're
an
still
established
evolving.
Fighter.
They're still evolving.
That your shit works when he's established, you know? So I just don't like when coaches, like, no disrespect to none of the UFC coaches. That and those gyms, because some of them are legit, but there's some that are not. Come on, man. I know a motherfucker that took 4 lessons from me, personal lessons, and is now the boxing coach at one of the UFC.
Yeah.
Like, you can even punch motherfucker. Yeah. Like, oh.
And I think that's another
thing. Like, how do you get credit or feel like you could tell someone, like, I'm a coach? Like,
you're not embarrassed.
Like, well,
Well, that's just a lie inside yourself. That's no integrity.
It's not even that.
That's no self-honor, you know what I mean?
You know, like, how can you tell yourself that? And, like, how can you go around?
I mean, that is just dangerous for the person that you're supposedly coaching and bringing up.
Oh,
like,
God, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Because you're throwing him to the lions, man.
Yeah. Fuck.
You know what I mean? Like, Jesus, bro. Like, what kind of person are you? You know what I mean?
My coach taught me to do this.
Yeah. You're not only stealing from them because you're lying about knowing what you know, and you're stealing their money
and
you're ripping
them
off. Now you're gonna fucking get them killed. You know?
That's the thing. You're responsible for somebody.
Exactly.
Yeah, dude.
You know, for sure. That's why I say, like, when my guys go out and I'm behind them 100%, I'm nervous for them. it's like I'm fighting. It's because that's me out there, because I'm going to get them everything out to prepare them, to get them ready for this fucking war they're about to walk in. I'm going to battle with them, you know what I mean? You know what? My heart's in there with them too, you know? Like, that's how I look at it. So that sense, like, and not only that, they're representing my name, so you better not, motherfucker, you better put it on.
What do I say all the time?
He does the same shit. He goes, don't fucking lose. Even when we're playing Jenga somewhere, he's like, don't fucking lose. Don't come back. You gotta come back to the gym.
If you're playing Jenga,
I fucking won that Jenga.
We were at the bar and he's playing Jenga. I was like, bitch, you better not lose or don't come back to this gym. If we were playing Jenga and he's playing water,
I won.
That's the pressure.
That's it. I'm getting a beer. That's all I'm
doing. Mindset, though, like, if you willingly know, like, well, you know, like, you got a reputation or whatever, like me, like, yeah, I might lose or whatever, but I'll tell you what, like, look at my losses. They're by decision, you know what I mean? Like, they're the tough guys. They ain't no chumsky motherfuckers, you know what I mean? And the thing is, like, you got a reputation, like, it's gonna show through, it's gonna shine through them, you know, when they step in there. It's like, motherfucker, like, I don't care if you lose. That don't worry about losing, you know? But you better not fucking quit, motherfucker. You better go out there and get everything you got, you know? Like, look at Nick. Like, Nick's losses are from chokes, but did he tap? Fuck no, he went to sleep. You better fucking get the fuck out. You're fucking going to sleep. You ain't fucking tap, motherfucker. You're gonna fucking die in that cage, you know? Like, I don't bring the fucking towel to the corner. What towel, motherfucker? There's no way. You fucking bring no towel. He dies, you know what I mean? Like, I'm gonna let you know, when I'm in your corner and you do your count with me, like, motherfucker, like, you're dying in there, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, and it is what it is. And I expect the same for me. Like, I'm in there fucking dying.
And I'm going to tell everybody
it's
right
now. It's a life situation, you know? Like I'm that's how I look at it. That's
everybody
my
right now, that is her. Like, you know? That is her 100%. Because I've seen him upset when people quit or bullshit. I've seen
they're wasting his time, you know?
Fucking anger.
Like, never putting time in him again.
I've been there to see his anger and be like, we put all this fucking time. I'm here. I could be with my family. I could train for myself. That's what a lot of people don't get. When a motherfucker that still can fight is putting time into you, he could be putting it for fuck himself, dude. Like, you have to have a whole different type of respect when a motherfucker is training for him to fight, for you to fight, but he's there. That whole analyzing everyone else is a fucking challenge. It's draining. As a coach, you don't just chill. Like, you're analyzing, like you said.
Yeah.
They're representing your brand. They're representing your name in a way. You know what I'm saying? 100%. Whether if it's game bread or not. If, like I said, if I were anything when I told them, hey, what were your game bread shit? I only said it for Bully. I'm not going to tell you for everyone else. Yeah. I'm only putting it for a fighter that I know is going to represent your model. Yeah. I'm not going to go tell him, hey, we'll wear game bread just to wear it.
Yeah.
No, if I'm going to take it to a fight, I'm going to take it with one of my guys that I know is going to fucking sit there and die in the ring. Because that's his model. That's his style. And if he's going to be like, yeah, man, cool, like, give us the opportunity to wear something that you don't just tattoo anything on yourself.
Yeah.
That's something you really fully 100% believe in.
You got that shit
then
for life.
Then I have to respect his belief in his brand.
Yeah.
Like, you cannot go to someone's brand and be like, oh, yeah cool. I mean,
I'm not saying, like, you have to be, like, crazy like me or whatever. That's just my philosophy.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, like, I expect go out there and give everything you got and fucking, like, if there was something, if you're fucking breathing and you could still push on, then do it, motherfucker. Don't just be like, oh, I want out. You know what I mean? No, fuck that. You know, you knew what was going on before you fucking stepped in there.
Exactly.
So now you better fucking own up to that shit and ride that shit out until the last fucking breath. You know what I mean? Because that's how I am. I'll always fucking be like that. You know? When I fight, I fucking give it everything I fucking got. You know, it showed in my last fights. Even when I'm getting crushed, I fucking come back. I'm still breathing. I'm fucking coming.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you fucking motherfucker better believe they're like, God damn, what the fuck? You know, how is he gassed the fuck out and he's still coming? You know why? Because I got heart and I'm fucking coming.
Yeah.
It's in my brain. Like, I won't quit until the body shuts down. It's like, I'm breathing, I'm fucking fighting. You know what I mean? Like, let's go. You know,
the thing I like about MMA, well, in boxing, the double-edged sword, like, when the trainer gets to go in the ring with them, I kind of don't like it because now they're putting you, like, well, he's the one who did it.
Yeah.
Like, you're on TV. And, like, the MMA guys kind of just, there's, like, five of them, so you really don't know. If you're not an MMA guy, you really don't know who the fucking head guy is.
Yeah.
You see a bunch of motherfuckers in the back.
Oh, yeah.
In boxing, this ain't you. They're like, Chief Second, and you have to go. And then you're in the middle. Like, I have fighters that I've stopped training because of that reason. Like, dude, we're not getting paid. We're doing this now for passion because you're not getting paid that much.
Yeah.
So at this point, you should be doing it and give 100% and listen. And why the fuck you have a corner if you're not going to listen? If you're going to do your own shit, then don't have a corner. Don't go up to a coach and be like, you want to train me and then do nothing that he says?
Yeah, that's something that you...
Like, come on, man.
You got to put your faith, I think, in your coach. You got to listen to him 100%. Exactly. And you got to know your grounds and respect what they say. Exactly. Because otherwise, then you shouldn't be your coach. You know, yeah, you're like going to argue with them and say, hey, no, this... Like, no, man. You got to put your trust and faith. If that's what who you choose...
That's why he's
there. And you got to listen and obey, man. Because they're the coach for the reason.
Like, if I went and said, hey, Herman, I want to do an MMA fight. And he's like, okay, but we're going to do this one. I'm not going to ask you what I want to do. You're going to tell me what I'm going to do, and I'm just going to fucking do it.
Right.
That's it. Like, I don't care if I have a boxing background. If you told me, hey, this fucker has nothing on the ground, Jose, nothing.
Yeah.
And I know you know some shit, and you tell me, Jose, this is what... I'm going to literally do that.
Yeah.
Why? Because that's why I went to him. That's why I went to him. Like, hey, Herman,
exactly.
I want to do an MMA fight now. You know what I'm saying? It's also up to the coach to know if someone's real with that shit. You're going to test me first. You're going to be like, okay, well, spar. Spar MMA.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Go in and spar.
Well, that's why, like I say, like, you know, you get guys that come into the gym like, oh, I want to be a fighter. Yeah, hey, okay, yeah, whatever. You know, that goes through one ear and comes out the other. Yeah. Unless they have fights or whatever, that's different. You know, then you give them a different respect and you give them a chance. You know, but they're like, this guy's like bone dry. Oh, what do I got to do to be a fighter? You got to show up to class. You got to learn first. You know, you got to be willing to learn. You got to be willing to accept the instruction. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then it's like, then you get to a certain level, you do this process, and then we're going to see if you got heart. That's the first thing. Because if you don't got that, then fuck you. I ain't wasting my time on you.
Something,
you know what I mean? Like, you could just do the classes if you want. I don't give a fuck. You know, but you ain't going to fight on this team. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Something like, I'm not going to bother you quit in the last minute. You know
what I like that you did was shout out Steve. But the way you told Steve, like, Steve, you have the talent. You just don't come here. So I'm not going to. I'm not going to promote. Like, the way Herman promotes is dope. Like, you got to do everything, motherfucker. I don't care if you're super talented and you're doing everything super gifted. Show the respect to the white belts the same way. Come in and be an example. Like, if you're being promoted, it's because you're going to be an example. You're the next level, so you should be in there. Like, I remember you telling him that. Like, I remember you telling him, like, look, man, you know how to do it, but you don't come.
Well, the thing about it is he's been doing it for a long time or whatever, but, you know, like...
The time and effort that you want to... But still, you have to put that time and effort. It's not just not just Steve, but I'm saying the way I've seen him promote or the way I've seen him, it's dope to me because it shows you that like you're not gonna be a part of my shit if you're gonna be some bitch. Like,
yeah,
you can't be a bitch in the fighting world. Sorry, like
you just gotta have heart. You know, like
it's unfortunate you can't be a bitch in the fighting game.
Yeah, you gotta have heart, man. Like
you said, it's unfortunate.
Yeah. Well, it is because like if you could just be super talented and be a bitch.
Well, that's the problem nowadays. They're breeding a lot of athletes. You know, like I said, like let's have this game plan. You know, yeah, it's smart in a sense. You know, like some people might say like the way that I think of fighting is fucking stupid. Oh, you're dumb. You know, like you ain't gonna make it far in the sport with that kind of mind mentality. That's just me. You know, I'm not saying it. The guys that I bring up or whatever got to be like that too and fight like that craziness. But I'm just saying like, you better show the fucking heart.
Yeah.
But of course, if we can instill skills, 100%, let's do the skills. But at the same time, it's like, you better not quit, motherfucker, from a soft situation where you could have worked your way out. You know what I mean? Because you the pressure got too tough or you got punched, you got rocked a little bit and you're like, fuck, oh God, tap. You know what I mean? Oh, fuck. You know what I mean? Like, motherfucker, you know what I mean? Like, fuck that. You know, like, go out fighting, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Go out fighting.
Do you ever feel like there's people that are tough in the gym and they do good and all of a sudden the pressure of the fans just got to them?
I haven't seen it personally, but I do know I've heard of a case like that. And I can easily see that happening.
I feel Nestor would have done better if everybody didn't yell. Because when I saw him come out that fight, I saw him freak the fuck out everywhere. Oh, because we were so many there to support him.
Yeah.
And I think that got to him a little.
Yeah. That's why I said, like, the mental game of the pressure comes in again, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, and like, I think because, the lack of his not doing amateur fights or the lack of experience of being in crowd.
Yeah.
Because I feel like you told him, like, he could have beat the guy. If,
yeah.
But it was just the pressure of being... Like, not having...
Well, you don't know what to expect.
That's what it is. I don't think he expected
it's
the
It's
just crap.
Different to you. It's new. You know what I mean? It's like, imagine if, like...
Because I go
they told us, oh, you're going to play with the NBA guys today. You're like, what?
Like, if you've never been to... Like, if
you're LeBron, you're LeBron's main guy. He's going to pass you the ball. You're like,
little show.
Oh, shit, you know?
like Molly, when he did his first HBO fight, he was more intrigued that Michael Buffer was in his name.
Oh, it's crazy. Yeah.
Like, he said the lights, the environment, the stadium, because he was the Coleman. So the stadium was already full. And this was when Terrence Crawford fought his first fight.
I know how that pressure is. Yeah, on TV.
He fought when Terrence Crawford in Omaha, in his hometown. So the fucking thing was packed.
Yeah.
So he fought and he said that the fucking lights just got to him because he never experienced that.
Yeah.
He was just like, that shit got to me. So this, so when we fought this time, the lights didn't affect him. Nothing affected him.
He was like, there before,
I already did
you
it.
You went through the motions. Now you got it down. Yeah. Like you smell the air. Like you can smell the fog from coming out, walking through. You step in the cage. You feel the canvas.
That's what gave me the confidence to take Bolito's type of fights or any fighter, because I've been in big fights already. I've been in like 4 world title fights. I've been the main event in almost all the fights with all my fighters. So I've been in the fucking thing full and where everyone's against us. I've been laughed at when Jolene won her world title with me. I told everybody, like, Jolene's gonna fuck this bitch up. And they were like, it's not even metaphor, laughing, like, like this fucking crazy little fuck, like, this young kid is stupid. Like, literally, in my face, basically telling me I was a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
Like, laughing at me. And, like, the pressure gets you, because then when you come out and they cheer for their hometown person, the ring shakes.
Like, when I fought Baseman, you know, it was closer to his hometown. We fought in Reno. We're the co-main event, you know, on Spike TV, you know, and
the fucking
and like Herman and Terrado, like, woo! You know what I mean? Like, you know, like, but again, you know, at the same time, you know, people say like, oh, they have an advantage because they're fighting at that place. If you're a real fighter, it don't fucking matter you are, you know what I mean? Like, you're there to fucking fight. You ain't gonna change the aspect of
But elevation is a bitch.
Oh, I know that, man.
Dude, because when we fought, when Jolene fought in Mexico, because we fought in this place called Metepec. It's 12,000 feet above sea level.
Well, I wasn't that fucking high, but
12,000, okay? We went from sea level to that instant. Because we flew there, so it's instant. You didn't acclimate, you didn't get to do shit. So when we got there, you're walking and you're like, fuck, man, you kind of feel this shit. Yeah. Like, you're like, oh, ah, but we're all like, it's like, I'm all trying to tell her, it's psychological. It's, don't worry about it, it's mental. Knowing damn well, like, I'm probably bullshitting, but you're trying to tell your fighter that shit. So we train, the fight goes. In the second round, she comes back to coach, I can't breathe. So I can't fucking breathe, She's all, it's not mental. She literally tell me that, like, it's not mental. It's like, I can't breathe. And I was like, no, trust me, it'll go away. Like, I'm still trying to. So she went 8 rounds with the pound for pound best fighter in women's. 8 rounds with 3 weeks of training.
It's crazy.
In high elevation. Any girl that's fought her since Jolene has only lasted 2 or 3 rounds.
Wow.
But it's that mindset of a warrior. Jolene's exactly a fucking warrior. Like,
oh, yeah, I'm ready.
Once, like, put you told her, I told her one time, like, no, you got this. It was like, cool, say no more.
Yeah.
Came back out round after round after, no matter how much pain. Her lungs, you could tell, like, how much she would not. I stopped the fight. That's what I told people. Now it comes to trainers, though. Like you were saying, the ref or the corner's job is to stop it. Your job is to fight. Like,
yeah.
That's the mentality of that book.
Yeah.
I felt like she don't need to go through this no more. And I don't give a fuck if a fighter gets mad at me. I've told all my fighters, get mad at me.
Yeah.
If I feel I need to stop this bitch, it's because I'm seeing something.
The coach decision, you know.
And I'm sorry. Yeah. So I went up and I threw the fucking towel and I was like, hey. It, man, like,
but you know, I ain't bringing out the towel still, so you
know. So sorry, guys. Sorry. I guess you're dying. You know? Like, I guess you're dying. If you're under Herman, you're dying. There is no towels. They don't, like, you don't have to take a towel. Like, in boxing, it's like, it's not like a, that's a rule. Like, we have to have a towel.
Oh, really?
Like, it's mandatory.
Huh. Yeah, the couple times in Bellator, they didn't even have them. Remember, they were like, hey, man.
Do you have a towel? What the fuck's a towel?
like, nah.
Like, what the hell's a towel?
They gave us a bucket, though. That's an ice. So
dude, in boxing, they don't give you shit, yo.
Really?
They're stingy, man. In Mexico, man. Shit, they don't even give you ice. Wow. You gotta go buy at the store, you buy a bag of ice, and everyone sees you buy ice, and now everyone's asking you for it.
17 years old, TJ, you know what I mean? our locker room was the bathroom, you know what I mean?
That shit is real, man.
You know, the toilet stall, you know what I mean? We had to share it because, you know what I mean? There's other fighters in there too. We're all like, hey, man, we got this, you know, toilet stall right here. Sit out, you know what I mean?
What's the funniest?
I've been to the bottom of the bottom. What's the funniest? Whatever you want to call it.
Street
you know,
fight there. You have without incriminating yourself.
Well, I've never been in one.
Yeah, you did? Yeah, I remember you said it last time. You never been in a street fight?
I've had a few. It's actually pretty close to here. You know what I mean? You know, but
you're a gamer.
No, yeah, I'm a gamer. But no, one time,
Call of Duty.
I was at a bar and somebody knocked the pizza out of a girl's hand. It wasn't even me. I was like down the street, probably like 100 yards, about to come to me, probably like your size. He walks up and he's like, "Hey, did you knock the pizza out of your hand?" I was like, "Yeah, it was me." You know, I'm getting drunk. I'm sitting there like,
"Holy wife, dog.
I'm sitting there like holding like a hot dog, and this bouncer just boom hits you straight in the face. I was like,
oh shit!
Right on my tooth. I was like, oh shit, I'm gonna get knocked out. My friend comes running out. He has a pool ball. Just And then this other security guard just fucking spraying like pepper spray. I got like pepper spray in my eyes.
Remember the beginning where I said don't incriminate yourself? Yeah. That was incriminating.
Well, he's white, isn't he?
He's white,
you don't know.
Statute of limitations.
I was like, I got like some salsa or something in my eyes. Me, don't fuck salsa, you guys. You're a man. I was like, oh shit, okay. And then
I got salsa in my eyes.
You crying? Kind of going at it, and then like these like Russian guys, I don't even know. They start chasing us. So remember, I take off running. I run by like a garden rocks. I grab a handful of rocks. I'm pepper spray at the time. I turn around and throw these rocks. I hit this guy with a blast double. I take him down. I get like kicked in the side of the head. I hear like a ring.
Oh, shit.
My friends over there get beat up, and I was like, who the fuck are you guys? They're like, yeah, you guys are one. And I'm like, no, we don't even know you. We don't want that, you know? And then we just all hop in the car and go home.
Like, together?
I had to get a root canal on my front tooth.
Really?
Yeah, I told him.
Like, you drove with the Russian guys?
No. My friends, they came across
the road. Oh, he saw we all got in the car.
Yeah,
like, damn,
that was awesome.
The next morning, first of all, I don't remember your pepper spray, but, like, you take a shower, flares right back up. It's like,
really?
You just took, like, fire all over your body.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
What do you mean? I've never been pepper sprayed.
I eat pepper spray.
What do you want to do?
I, like, woke up to, like, eat some food, dude. I couldn't even, like, crunch on a piece of lettuce. My front tooth was like...
No, but what do you do about the pepper spray? What are you supposed to do to take it out?
Pour milk.
Fucking...
Oh, really?
They say that, but that shit didn't work, dude.
You pour milk in your
face? I don't know.
Okay, you took a shower, not fucking milk. So you know when you're...
Yeah, I put like milk on my face and shit.
When you eat something spicy and you drink water, all you're doing is spreading it. That's why it burns worse. You're not supposed to drink... what he did was put fucking steaming hot water probably.
Oh, shit.
And that fucking
it was, like,
spread
burning,
it.
Burning, like,
but milk works. Like, if you're fucking eating something that's too spicy, drink some milk. It'll go away. It works.
Yeah.
I've done it.
Yeah, it was... I mean, you had to be there, though.
I never gotten like that. Like, I mean, I've gotten some good ass fights, but
every fight that I got in is because Mark Pineda, of course, that we got in here over here at the Just so everyone know, every street fight that ever got started was because Mark Pineda.
Dude, that was in your North Park days, though, right?
He always started it, but he didn't finish it. Yeah, Mark. Yeah, you know what's up.
Well, that was in the North Park days.
Yeah, man, U31.
Yep, it has to be U31.
You know what I mean? U31 is ghetto as fuck right now.
There was no two notes or anything like that, you know. But there's no street fights, street fights always started because Mark Pineda. I mean, even when we go to Yuma, Arizona and fight Mark Pineda again.
Do you have like your group of friends who like acts extra tough because he knows that you're a fighter and you got his back and shit?
Not currently. I won't hang out with the guys like that, you know, because they're going to bring trouble to me, you know.
But when you were younger?
In the past, yeah.
Yeah, like if I'm out, I'll be
and honest. They always pick the biggest fucking guy to fuck with, too. I'm like, bro! You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck, man? You know what I mean? Like, shut the fuck up, you know? Like,
you know this guy's a professional fighter, right?
Yeah.
That's already a setup.
Yeah. Exactly, you know?
I don't do none of that shit, man.
But street fights, yeah, I don't do street fights. I don't even.
Nobody has time for that.
Not the startup.
There's really no point either.
I'll defend myself, you know. But I
that's my philosophy.
Some guy bumps into me. Yeah,
you know, like you end up hurting somebody bad, and then, you know, fuck
jail time.
Yeah.
And then I heard him. Everybody got phones now.
Or you break your hand punching some dumbass.
Yeah,
in the face
some stupid.
You'll never see him ever again in your life, you know. And it's like, fuck, broke my hand, motherfucker. You know what I mean?
Now you can't train for.
I want to go to jail too. You know, like fuck. For your dorky ass, you know what I mean? Because you're an idiot, you know?
You're not
fuck
worth
that,
it.
You know? Yeah, fuck that. I already know I'll beat you up, you know? That's good enough for me, you know? Like, I'd be, you know what I mean? In the back of my mind, that's all I'm thinking, you know? I'm like, whatever. Unless you're, like, physically antagonizing me, touching me, then I'm going to defend myself to a certain extent. But I'm not going to be like, yeah, fuck you, motherfucker. Incident. You know, fuck that.
I honestly, I got in more fights in soccer games than, like, just... being a fighter.
Yeah.
Dude, hell of soccer fights. Like, it was always a fucking fight. Like, what the fuck, man? Like,
the hooligans.
It's almost every game I had. No, because I used to play soccer. My brother played professional soccer. And I used to play, you know, trying to be big bro. Always, you know, you try to follow footsteps.
There you go.
But fuck, every game we got in fights.
Yeah.
Not him. He was like, he doesn't like fighting.
I think that's just a Latin culture thing.
Every soccer game.
Because you know at least like four of them know how to box at least.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Like, fight. Like, you know, it's like that. You know, like
bloody fights. Like not like some bullshit. Like, it was some fights. Like serious. Like people were fucking being fucking unconscious, comatose and shit. Like, yeah, headbutts, you know, like, are good. Well, see, I'm infamous for headbutting. That's why I headbutt to this day.
Oh, shit. Yeah, headbutt's dangerous, man.
I headbutt motherfuckers all it's dangerous. Day.
It's hard to see it coming. It's, you know? Just like, you, boom. Like, someone's face.
Fuck up your nose. Your eyes are all wide.
Anytime you fuck around with some soccer player, be prepared for that head to be coming towards you. That's like a signature move in soccer. Like, it's soccer.
It's probably good at it, too, for the ball. You know,
it's a headbutt followed by a soccer kick.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. By a motherfucking soccer kick.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's when it gets real.
Yeah.
Like, them soccer kicks, man. Y'all motherfuckers be doing soccer kicks. It looks like it.
Yeah.
Like, a low kick looks like a fucking soccer kick.
Like,
But Pride used to do that, right? Like, you just soccer kick someone in a fucking headpiece.
He's the curves on him.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's real fighting, you know?
That's fucking dope.
Keeps you honest, you know what I mean?
So. All right, man, we're going to wrap it up. That's like 2 hours now that we've been chopping it down. And thank y'all motherfuckers
for coming.
Yeah, thank you, Russ. Thank you, Russ.
Good to see you, man.
Yeah, thanks for having us. You looking, Jamey?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know.